Good evening and welcome to the Board of Selectmen's meeting for Tuesday, May 24th. Ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone. I will entertain a motion to approve the minutes of the Board of Selectmen's meeting for 4/12.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Announcements, the annual Memorial Day Parade will be held Monday, May 30th. Member, marchers and all units will assemble at 10 a.m. at the Brookfield Elementary School. Fellow citizens, comrades of any military organization, veterans of all wars, all servicemen and women, town of Brookfield Police, firefighters, first responders, civil defense, emergency medical technicians, Sons of American Legion and VFW, scouts, 4-H youths, recreational teams, students and parade units are invited to join Brookfield residents in a proper observation of this day. Local Public Access Committee is seeking members. The committee is also seeking videographers to tape meetings and local events. Those interested should contact Ms. Mahoney at localaccess@brookfieldma.us. Any other announcements?
Yes, I would like to announce on Saturday, the 28th at 10 a.m., we're going to be doing dedication of our bridge. It'll be the Joseph F. Murray Memorial Bridge, and this is the first time ever in the town that we have dedicated a bridge to anyone. So all are welcome to come out. It's rain or shine.
And it's going to be warm.
And the Murray kids will be at the Brookfield Congregational Church at Fellowship Hall somewhere between 8 and 9:30 for coffee if people would like to come and visit.
Any other announcements? Anybody wish to address the board this morning? Or this morning, this evening? Mr. Holcraft, welcome.
That's on purpose, David, I did.
I just did that on purpose. All right, I spoke to you three about that truck accident that we had. The highway truck accident back on February 5th.
I'm assuming privately because we never brought it up in a meeting.
Yeah, we never brought it up.
I talked to each of you privately. Mm-hmm. And what's being done. I want to know why it was a cover-up in our town. We didn't see any bills come through the advisory board for repairs. No insurance claim was put in. I went to the town accountant and she had nothing. So this is the third accident in the last few years. So I don't know what's the, so kind of some, you, all three of you did not know what took place. You didn't know anything about the accident.
No.
So when we have a truck accident, if it's an ambulance, fire truck, highway truck, police car, you don't get notified.
No. I'm not trying to hide anything.
So what you're saying is the department head, something happens, we can just scurry it and no one knows anything about anything.
Not my understanding, but that's fine.
You were the first one to tell me about it?
You were the first one to tell me.
My discussion
okay,
with
so have you done the inquiries to what happened and why it happened?
My discussion with you is you were going to vet it with Mr. Snyder, who is our unofficial liaison with the highway department.
Yeah, I did that. I got nowhere.
So my question is, what did you find out?
Well, I found out there was a truck accident on February 5th up on Gay Road.
And all things were reported.
Huh?
And it was reported.
It was reported to who?
Police chief had a file.
Yeah. Okay. Did he report it to you?
No.
Okay. So this is what I'm asking you: what the procedure in the town of Brookfield? If there's a truck accident, how does this work?
If there's an equipment failure, I'd term it that way.
Yeah. After the truck had crashed, yeah, the tire was almost ripped off. Yeah.
Well, okay. It hit an area in the road, and things happened, and things were reported, and they were fixed.
Oh, so you knew? So you knew this took place?
No,
you're down at the highway barn all the time.
Yeah, from time to time, yes.
Okay, so you know.
I had no knowledge. You reported something. Mm-hmm. I asked the proper authorities. Had things been reported? And so, I mean, if your issue is that we're somehow delinquent in our responsibilities, I would disagree.
know, you could just, that's fine. But I want to, to me, this is a cover-up of what's going on in this town.
I would suggest otherwise.
Yeah, but we have a major truck in our town that gets seriously damaged. The tow truck was up there for hours getting the truck off the road. And no one knows anything. We haven't seen any bills. Was an insurance claim filed?
No, not that I know.
Okay.
Not that I know.
So how did the truck get fixed and repaired?
Must not have been that serious.
Well, the tire was just about off. It was hanging.
So how do you know it was hanging?
It was hanging, and the fender was crushed in.
So how do you know this?
I see it.
You physically saw it?
Physically saw it. Not me, no. Someone else physically saw it.
Someone was plowing, something happened. It happened, it was reported, and it was fixed. I mean, that's what you pay people to go do, get the work done.
So in order not to belabor this any longer, I would recommend that we request the administrative assistant to either ask Cindy or Herb to, through an email, to correspond with the Board of Selectmen of what happened, how it was fixed, and then we'll have it documented.
Sure.
And then now we got to go to the next step.
You okay with that?
The reason this happened was you were up on a small country road plowing with a wing plow. You shouldn't be having a wing plow on a narrow street up there. Wing plow is for wide streets, okay?
Well, I would probably...
So, I mean, that's...
I'll stay quiet for a moment.
Okay, so what I'm saying is, well, I want your input. What I'm saying to you, you three, is we shouldn't... The procedure of plowing a small country road with a wing plow should not be taking place. That's what I'm telling you. That's
again,
probably why the accident took place.
I would think that that was your opinion, and that you're paying people to do their job, and they happen to use a piece of equipment that they happen to choose and they have experience with. I happen to live on Gay Road, and I happen to have seen a wing plow go by my driveway. And I thank the person that was driving it very much for pushing the snowbank back so I can see when I come to the end of my driveway. So I would disagree with you that it's a bad practice.
Oh, it definitely is. Definitely. You don't use a wing plow on a small country
and again,
road.
Neither you nor I are certified to drive those vehicles, so I would suggest that we turn to those that we employ with those credentials for their best information and their direction.
And we did that, and we got into a truck accident because of the wing plow being on there. So that practice and certification is not the right way.
Without speculating anymore, we'll wait till the report from the highway department, and then we'll address it from there.
And probably in the future, we should, if anything happens within any other departments, you know, if there's an accident or anything, they should report it to us, so we know and we don't have to find out.
I mean, this is you know, this is a point I'm trying to make here. Is this town, do we have any management, or do we have any people that are going to be accountable for their actions? I mean, it's just people do whatever they want. Something happens, they're just all covered up. I mean, this is what I'm seeing when I've been on this advisory board. I see a lot going on in this town. Everything is just every which way.
I disagree. We've had several executive sessions to discipline several employees. Yeah. A couple of them resulting in termination. So the management is there.
Some management is there, Steve.
From what I'm hearing, it was an accident that was reported to the police department, which, in my definition of a cover-up, that is the truest undefinition of a cover-up, if that's a word.
Well, the road was shut down. They had to have the road shut down for quite a while to get the truck out.
So that's definitely not a cover-up. So I'm done with this conversation. So we'll find out from the administrative assistant in the highway department, and we'll move forward with that.
Okay. So what's your future procedure on this type of activity? If we have
all accidents have been reported to the police department. That's who it needs to be reported to.
So you three just. You're the executive branch, you're their bosses, or whoever it is, and you know nothing what's taking place. That's what you're telling me right here, right now.
I think we know what's taking place, but from what I'm hearing, it wasn't that bad of an accident. The police department doesn't have to call the Board of Selectmen up every car accident and report to us.
Who doesn't?
The police department.
Every time there's like an accident here in town, I mean, they don't have
We're not talking about private citizens in their vehicles. We're talking about town-owned vehicles. That's what you three are in charge of.
Yeah.
With the employees that are behind the wheel of these vehicles.
And when the warrants come in, we see it. Yeah. We're advised.
That's what we usually
see. When the garage door was struck, we knew about it. It was taken care of.
Okay, what about this?
That you were the first one that told me about it.
Well, that's my point. So,
and we didn't see anything.
So for the fourth time, we're going to find out through the highway department what happened, and we'll move forward from there.
Okay.
So I'm done. I'm done with this conversation.
All right. Because I brought this up to you 3-4 weeks ago. So.
Anything else?
Okay. When are you going to have that information?
I would assume by the end of the week.
Next meeting.
We'll address it in our next meeting.
Next meeting.
Okay. All right. I'll be waiting for it.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? Welcome, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Just a couple of quick things. A couple of three selectmen meetings ago, we were talking about the town hall rehab plan,
mm-hmm.
and we talked about doing a presentation to the people so you kind of hear what was going on. Is that?
Through another meeting, we decided not to do
not
it.
Not to do it.
Okay.
Because we weren't going to go after me. I wanted to go full steam in here with partitions and whatnot. Through discussion, we decided not to do that and just start with the bathroom. So we agreed that there didn't need to be a public hearing for that.
I guess I wasn't aware that that got struck. Kind of an update from QQLA. We got. Over the last 4 years, we've been treating North Pond and South Pond for invasive weeds. The report that I got from our environmental consultant this week is that there are no weeds, invasive weeds in South Pond. That they have been totally wiped out at this point. It doesn't mean we're not going to watch and treat it. And North Pond has seen a significant decrease in Eurasian milfoil. Fan wart is another problem, but
The milfoil down there was horrible.
Yeah, the milfoil is treatable. The fan wart, not quite so well. But anyway, I just want to let you know that we've had great results with the treatment over the last 3 years, and we're going to continue. When I get the map of the weeds that were. Mapping each year is done in May, so when I get that map, I'll be glad to share it with you.
Thank you.
One other thing I wanted to ask, and I know it's on the agenda, is about the trees on the beach.
I was actually going to ask you before you left, did you ever check into the lease to see who's responsible for the trees?
I didn't check into the lease. I don't have a copy of it. I think...
Karen has
it. There's a copy in there. I put it in...
So I don't know whose responsibility is.
It's under trees.
I think the town is licensed to use it as a town beach. Mm. And there are certain stipulations with that license. And I don't know as far as cutting down the trees.
Well, I guess I knew is that Cindy contacted Bill Davis to tell Bill that something needed to be done with the trees. And that... in the past, that's how they've handled it. They've just notified.
Yeah, and that may be what it is, that they don't have any qualms with what you want to do. You know, just let them know and coordinate
That's how it's been handled in the past.
And they're pretty easy to work with in that regard.
Bill's
so,
been very helpful.
QQLA is having a picnic at the beach on Saturday.
Yeah.
Are the trees coming down on Saturday?
No.
Okay. I thought I read that somewhere.
That was an early plan.
Well, we through that, I don't know how it got concocted to do a Saturday removal, but we have a policy that we can't do comp time, and that's what the superintendent was requesting. Through discussion with the tree warden who just... I came in at my request. We could go out to bid for other companies to do it if the highways sub can't do it outside of that Saturday. I haven't looked at this. I'll look at this during our meeting and see who's liable for it. Maybe even make a copy for our tree warden. We'll move forward from there.
The last one I had was, again, a number of meetings ago, there was discussion about the looking at the dilapidated buildings in town, and the Board of Health was going to take over that issue. Is there any update on that?
We have a citizen's petition that we placed in the town meeting warrant that's requesting that the town does not use the Secretary of State's program. So as far as the board's concerned, we're on a hold until that vote. I think the Board of Health is as well. I don't know if they're involved with that petition or support that petition.
So nobody's doing anything at this point?
Not until that petition gets voted on the 10th. Because unfortunately, it's all for naught. And I'm not going to push something through that the citizens of Brookfield don't want.
No, I just wanted to find out what the status was.
But as far as I'm concerned, things will get rolling along after the 10th with that vote.
Okay.
Ready? Thanks.
Thank you.
Anybody else wish to address the board? All right, I'm going to change the agenda a little bit. Time restraints for our tree warden. So number three, if the tree warden can come on up, I'd appreciate that. South Pond Beach Trees. There was a request by a citizen, and welcome, sir.
Thank you.
To remove three hazardous trees. The highway superintendent deemed that those were hazardous with a request for $840 to remove those on a Saturday with his subcontractor. Discussion with the tree warden through emails and whatnot, you know, questioning the responsibility of it and then obviously the timing of it. So the floor is yours, sir.
I'm sorry?
The floor is yours.
Oh, thanks. Well, I haven't had an opportunity to view the trees as of yet. I don't know what the locations are of the trees in question. So once I've determined where those trees are, what those trees are, and I've had an opportunity to take a look at them and assess the trees, I think then we can move forward confidently in the direction to indicate then who the responsible party is. Understanding that the town is leasing the property, I think it would come under whoever the ownership is or whoever is responsible for maintaining the property in the lease. So, and I'm not familiar with that lease or any of the language within. So I guess my role then would be to have a look at those trees, assess the condition of the trees, make a determination.
Can you make the only thing I see in here that speaks to maintenance is number four in the cover letter. The town will be responsible for maintenance of the beach and the removal of all litter. You could argue that the trees are the beach. I would argue that they're not.
Yeah.
That's what we have lawyers for, that they make those arguments and they're practicing law. So I'm going to give you a phone number on this if you could contact them tomorrow.
Sure, I'd be happy to.
Do you have a piece of paper? Just past you. Yeah. You won't be able to read my handwriting, so I'll let you write your stuff.
And then I won't be able to read mine.
That number there is what I'm seeing. The contact, that's the license.
Who's the contact on that?
Divisions of Fisheries. And
yeah, that's Bill Davis.
Okay, I'll call on those folks and
and call me tomorrow.
I will.
As soon as possible.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, Cindy has, in an email earlier today, reached out to Bill.
Okay.
And just for location and identification, Ken Cleveland's just entered the room, and Ken, at my suggestion, went down there to respond on behalf of CONCOM as far as their feelings towards the removal of the trees. So maybe Mr. Cleveland could express his understanding of where the trees are and what their condition is.
I talked to our insurance carrier this afternoon, and he wanted to know if they were on the beach. And I said, I don't think they're on the beach. I think they're off, actually on the side of the road. There's plenty of beach down there, but you can see where four branches have fallen on the beach. So when you have a lot of kids there, safety is, I feel bad for the trees, but if there's even marginal decay, it's safer to take the tree down.
Or pruning. So is there any way you could possibly take a ride tonight or tomorrow to look at those?
Yeah, I'll have a look at those trees tomorrow morning.
I'm gonna argue it's the state's responsibility. So if the state could send a crew down there to prune, if not remove.
So I would think it'd be up to them to prove otherwise.
And time to me is of the essence. We have, you know, the official, unofficial opening of summer coming this weekend, and safety is a huge issue down there with kids, let alone anybody.
Now, are those trees identified in any way?
Well, the tops of them are dead. There's like 20 feet, pieces are broken off the tops of the trees. And like I said, there's several branches on the ground from there, so.
Okay.
Pretty soon there's going to be a lot of little kids there.
Oh, sure. Yeah, no, that's my first concern, but I mean, the trees are easily recognizable as being in decline.
I was teasing Herbie. I said, "Yeah, well, I'm drilled. We can drill through and see how hollow it is, because that gives you a dead. If it's dead,
yeah.
You know, however good it looks."
Yeah. Okay, I'll make a phone call in the morning then, and look at the trees, and then
get back to me immediately tomorrow.
To let you know.
Excellent. Absolutely. So we're going to hold off on the reserve fund request because we don't know.
That's fine.
Okay. Any other comments, questions, concerns on?
Would you then like me to get pricing?
I'm not the most optimistic individual in the world, but I'm feeling that the state is responsible for them.
Okay.
So if you can really push that through that conversation tomorrow.
Absolutely.
If it's not going to happen, then obviously we do need pricing.
Okay. Yeah.
Can I just?
1 second, Kent. Did you have a question, Kent? No. Good. Set. Yep.
Quick recommendation, just because all of us only meet so often, it might make sense to at least consider the reserve fund transfer, because we have adequate funds remaining in the reserve fund. Whether it sits in the reserve fund or it sits in the tree warden's account, doesn't matter for the end of the year closure. And then depending on how the fisticuffs come out between us and the state, you at least have the option.
If you guys don't have a problem with reserve fund and you're saying that now,
have to check with the committee. I'm just saying it would be at least worth considering tonight because we only meet so often.
But this has been considered on my end. We can deficit spend. We can incur that expense, and we can pay the bill, and then we can deal with it later through that transfer.
Usually you have to identify the source of the municipal transfers before you deficit spend. Yeah.
And it'll all be done.
Okay. If you're comfortable with doing it that way,
I'm comfortable with it.
Fine.
It to me, it's not the money. To me, it's the delegation of the project, and it'll get done.
I absolutely get it. I'm just saying it's from a standpoint of...
No, I appreciate it.
The velocity is important in this instance based on the safety evaluation.
The velocity is going to be determined by Mr. Stendrup and his conversation tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
I know you guys weren't around when we built the boat ramp. She was. And when they did that, they cut every tree down, so they wouldn't have any responsibility after.
So to me, that means they're responsible for it.
Well, it was state. As soon as they got under the water, it was state.
My only concern is that if it becomes a responsibility of the state, it's going to get dragged down in red tape, and it won't be done for months.
Right.
That's my only concern.
Yeah. I'm pretty good on the phone.
Yeah, and that's where I'm trusting you calling them tomorrow.
Okay.
All right?
Sure. Sorry, we're Michael.
All right. Any other discussion? All right. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Item number 2, seasonal worker. Karen, how's our outreach to the local schools? No responses?
Just a thank you for considering us.
Cindy said, we talked about, we had personnel. Cindy says nobody's reaching out.
All right. One individual has taken his name out of the running, so we're left with one individual. They're averaging a $10 to $12 an hour.
Who? Can we see who it is?
Yeah. And through outreach to the highway superintendent, he was okay with either.
How did these names come about?
They actually approached the highway department from
the
hearing.
Good.
That's probably I know the other one.
I know I had talked to a bunch of people to suggest they go talk to her, so that's great.
And we're better off to hire somebody because they've been putting in
overtime, which I'm not a fan of, but I'm keeping quiet.
But they're trying to keep up. They don't have anybody to mow the lawn, so they have to.
I wish Herb was here to discuss this. How many hours were we talking about?
Well, this is for the seasonal worker.
Dave, have you had conversation with how many hours the highway?
It has to be 40 hours a week.
They want 40 hours a week?
During the season. But
that's what they wanted?
Up till end of November.
And that's what it's budgeted for?
I thought it was November 1st.
Well, November 1st, but then they went, they had this person help pick leaves up, so.
I didn't think it was.
So it was $40 an hour till when?
Not 40 hours. 40 hours.
I caught it, as it was coming, as it was passing my lips.
I didn't realize, Dave, it was 40 hours a week.
I didn't either, I thought it was like 20. But you guys have had the conversation, so 40 hours until when?
November 1st, or depending on the funding, if they'd like to have someone to the end of November, depending on the weather, we're picking leaves up.
I know that there is still money, Cindy said there was still money in the end of account until July 1st.
Basically to November 1st.
No, but there's still money this year, it's a whole month's worth of money in that account.
Yes, there is.
During the calendar year, so they wouldn't hit 900 this calendar.
Okay, because there's money left if we hired it now.
Correct.
Before July 1st.
All right, so I'm going to entertain a motion to appoint Mr. Gerstall at the rate of $12 an hour for 40 hours until November 1st as a seasonal employee for the highway department.
Now I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
I just think we should check into that 40 hours a week because I didn't realize it was 40 hours.
Every member from the advisory committee is saying 40 and it's budgeted, so I'm okay with it.
Is it?
Sounds good.
Okay.
Any further discussion? No. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Item number four, Mr. Siri had requested us to put North Pond Boat Ramp on. Is there Mr. Toto?
Yes, he's here.
Welcome, sir. How may we help you?
Well, there's two things I need. The town has a vendor's permit that I have to get. At no charge, which the last time I got one, but after the town wants me to have one of those. And they're also interested in where I like to set up. And I have done on town property before at the West Brookfield Line, and I've done it at A1 Sports, and I've done it at Bay Package Store. Other places had problems with the size of the lot when the tractor trailer was there delivering beer at Bay Pass Spirits, and then I'm there. It's totally congested, so it hasn't worked out right for myself or even the businesses. So I looked at the spot across from the boat landing, and the town owns 150 feet of frontage over there. And it's everything's pushed back, so I just wanted to let the town know that that was where I thought I would like to set up. I cannot set up on a boat landing. It's a state permit that's only good for 1 8-hour period a year. So, but I'm not using the boat landing. There's a toilet facility right there. They have a handicap porta potty in. And I would not, no picnic tables, no chairs, no.
So what's the request?
To be able to just use that spot. I was told when I first set up back in 5 or 6 years ago, it upset someone in town and they said, we just can't have people setting up anytime, anywhere they want to. So I had been always giving you guys written permission from the owners to use their property to satisfy that request. So we are the owners of that property. I'm a town resident, so I want to use that spot and then wanted the town to know it, and I guess basically.
Where is this? Is it on the side where the porta potty is, or the?
No, I would directly north of the boat landing. There's an area that probably goes back 20 feet off the road. I pulled in there the other day, and I've got this much distance between me and the edge of the road, so it's not that close to the road. And like I said, I have no picnic tables, no waste baskets and stuff like that. When I leave, the whole system goes with me as well.
So we've basically taken a stance and an unwritten policy that we don't allow vendors to set up on town land. I'm sticking with that. I'm only one of three. When you talk about, you're talking about 148, right?
No, Quaybach Street.
Quaybach Street.
Right across from the state boat landing.
Okay.
We're 150 feet of front.
Oh, across from the boat landing.
Yeah, I can't do it on the boat.
And that's town property where the parking is. And with trailers and whatnot, that's even more of an issue to me. So I'm sticking with my unwritten policy not to allow town use for public vendors.
All right, so do I still need the permit?
Well, it's up to, I'm only one of three. I'm not a majority.
So this is across the street from the boat landing?
Yes.
So?
Yeah, that open area.
With a parking, it's a parking lot.
No one parks across the street.
across the street from the boat
lane. This is on the north side of the boat lane. This is across Quay Bog Street and towards the swamp. The lake, the river, and then the riverside.
That's a parking lot, isn't it?
No.
No, it's not a park. It's just a...
pull-off area. It's almost like a pull-off area.
Yeah, I know what he's talking about. The little pull-off area.
Yeah, no one pops over there. Maybe during the ice fishing derby, the local police might have their crews over there. But no one uses that area for parking or not a bus stop. It's not like this, just a section of barren land on the side of the road.
So I guess my question, I'm a little new. So we're talking a food concession that you've run there for a number of years?
Yeah,
he's run it quite a few years.
Okay,
but so in different locations.
In different locations.
Always on private property. Yeah.
Proper, okay,
not,
so
not
that,
public
that's
land.
One thing.
Not the first time. The first time I set the sign entering Brookfield on this side of the night. Brookfield sign, I was there.
Down by the old rest.
To go to A1 Sports.
The old rest.
Yeah, he was down by the old rest stop.
It's portable, like I said. It's all behind my truck. It's self-contained.
Okay.
To me, it's just a liability issue, setting the town up, and then fairness to other people. It hasn't been vetted by a police department for traffic or accidents or...
Yeah, and understand that position, sure.
Yeah.
The second piece is back to meals taxes and those kinds of things. Does the town benefit from your...
Well, meals tax is a state issue that
that's state issue.
Okay, so we don't have any...
No, we don't have any.
So from a meals tax perspective, you're paying in that way. Okay.
If he's filing, but it has nothing... If he's filing, it has nothing to do with the town, though.
Right.
Could we check this out with the chief to see what the traffic flow is down there?
I'm just telling you, we're going against every other person we said no to.
Yeah, circling back around, if we've said no to the use of town land, then the answer is no.
Yeah, because I knew we had somebody that wanted to set up on the common, and we wouldn't want to set up on the common either.
Full time? On the common, or just for adventuring?
No, he wanted to set up on the common.
I believe it was for the summer season.
For the summer season.
Yeah. Well, I'm not really in the middle of anything like the common. I mean, just on the side of the road. But I could see we probably wouldn't want it on the common.
And down there, it is kind of a congested area. And I mean, the cars fly through there like crazy.
They fly through there.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah, 30 miles
home.
Yeah,
but
you can see in both directions.
But they don't they don't go 30 down there.
But it does have a double solid yellow line through there, so it would be no.
That
cash.
Doesn't make any difference.
I lived down all my life.
Yeah, so I know.
We
know.
And it's absolutely nothing personal.
No.
I hope you're not taking it that way on my end.
No, it's nothing personal on it.
I've been on this board for over 5 years, and that's just what we're still.
That's the problem.
Well, I'm also a carpenter, and I'm allowed to go anywhere to do my carpentry. So it's hard to balance that out. Why it's okay for me with my carpenter's license to go in anybody's yard or do any work I need to. Yet with the cart, it's like, well, we don't want that.
Well, you still have to get permitted to do construction jobs.
Depending, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you have to get your building permit through the communities to do that.
For some stuff, not all stuff.
It's kind of like comparing a knife to an apple.
Say that,
having a construction supervisor's license and a vendor's license is like comparing a knife to an apple. It has nothing to do with anything.
Well, it depends. People don't come to me. I go to them, and the town doesn't care what time or what house or how long I'm going to be at this place.
It's private property.
Yeah,
We're talking about public land.
Well, even when I was on private property, I was asked those same questions. How long are you going to be there? What's your menu?
By the town?
Yeah.
Well, that'd probably be the Board of Health.
Yeah.
That would be.
Yeah.
I've been doing it for quite a while. I've been doing it for 04.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it was back a ways. But my menu was questioned.
Not by this board.
That would have been the Board of Health.
This is just location. I have no problem with you setting up on private land.
I still need that vendor's permit.
I think that would be the Board of Health.
That's Board of Health. Yeah, that's
then
Board of
Health. The Selectmen gave it to me again, but the Selectmen actually...
I've never issued a vendor's license.
Yeah. The Selectmen
ever.
Actually want to be the stop.
Is Mike's...
The business.
Is Mike
still? Mike's in his office still, I believe.
No, even the little other one, that like the little trolley car thing he's got, he's never come to us to get a vendor's license. I think that all comes from the Board of Health.
It didn't then.
It should now, because it's serve safe and all that.
Yeah, and I have all that. I just don't have a permit from the Board of Health, because he's on vacation. I think I run out June 1st, my regular permit. He should be back very soon. So I couldn't set it up now anyway.
Is there any way to work with this gentleman for a vendor's license, or does he have to go somewhere else?
Oh, a vendor's license. Oh, I thought you were talking about permitting.
No.
No, you do the, of course, the...
The vendors? We've...
I've never done a vendor's license.
It's a little pad about this big.
No.
And you fill it out.
We do the food or the mobile vending permit.
That's what that is, it's a mobile, yeah.
Oh, yeah, we inspect his cart and we issue a permit.
And that's a different one. I get that one from the inspector. One that had out.
A vending, I don't ever remember even...
A business certificate, that would be through the town clerk.
No, he gets that from me.
Yeah.
That's entirely different.
So my recommendation is to ask him what he really wants, and if it is on the Board of Selectmen, it's something new to me.
If I'm correct, you just want to set up your mobile cart.
Right, but the town wanted me to have a vendor permit. I had to come in here.
Well, it won't be on town through, and Clarence, have you made up your mind? This is still in the air. Are we going to continue?
No, I'm clear with you.
Yeah, I am too.
Not on town land.
So unanimously, we're not going to allow him to set up on town property.
Okay.
So he still has the ability to set up on private property, but he's looking for licensing to do that.
I recall what you went through before regarding this vending. For some reason, you had to come back. Am I correct? You came before this board one other time?
For this permit.
Maybe another board.
Now, this was during another... Yeah,
it was good for a year. It came from the town. It was signed by the selectman.
Don Nealon was here at that time. I remember this issue because for some reason he was sent here. What prompted that back in that time? I forget. It was just some unusual circumstance that came up. You'd been in business for some time.
Someone issued
permits from us, but this was something entirely different.
Exactly. I had been doing this for years at a racetrack in Connecticut, and when I set up over here at the West Brookfield town line, someone from the town saw me there and came in and said, we just can't have someone set up anywhere and do whatever they want, whether it is this. And immediately I was told to stop work until the next selectman's meeting to come in and get a permit.
Can you bring a copy of that to our administrative assistant tomorrow?
I might have it, but it's just a piece of paper. It didn't even cost anything. But
if you can bring that to the town acknowledging the fact that I had the right to,
that was between 2007 and 2009.
Could be.
In fact, Jimmy, you know what? I probably got some old emails in regards to the situation because it went back and forth between Jeff Taylor and the zoning enforcement officer. I'll do some research.
Okay, and then we'll just work on that.
Yeah, Jimmy Allen signed it. That's how long ago.
Sure.
Yeah, a long time ago.
Now, you have your state vendor's permit.
Which would have been expired by now.
Yeah.
You have the state.
Yeah, I have all that. I have my state syrup. I have an inspection. They've inspected my kitchen inside. They've inspected my storage area outside and my cooking area outside, my freezers. And I'm good to go. I just wanted to run it by you guys to set up there.
Well, we're not discouraging from private property. So if you need anything from us, let us know.
Okay.
Yeah, right?
And Michael will research that permit, I guess.
And like I said, if you have a copy of that, if you can bring it in.
I'll have a look. I keep most of my stuff, so I probably can't.
Okay.
And then we can research what they did.
Okay. Yeah, it didn't even cost anything. This was
A piece of paper that they made you jump through.
Yeah, they made
the cost of the printing.
Yeah.
Right, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Item number 5, municipal relief transfer. There's 2 requests. Hasn't made it before the advisory committee, but make it through us tonight if you'd like. First request is from Michael Seri, Cemetery Commission, requesting a transfer of $1,685 from cemetery payroll to perpetual care. Only $892 remaining in the account at this time. Used last wages during same time last year to determine what will be needed to get through the remainder of the year. Entertain a motion to approve transfer.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
For Michael Seri as well, a request for $1,050 from the Board of Health expense to the transfer station expense. Earlier in the fiscal year, Chairman Leahy successfully completed the Mass Title V Soil Evaluator Certificate class. Board agreed to reimburse Dan for his training. After he got a certificate, we anticipated a shortage. I'm basically requesting that $1,050 to cover it. And entertain a motion for municipal relief transfer.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
It's a copy of Dan's.
I just wanted to get that amount.
Give that to the chair before they leave tonight. Maybe they can act on it tonight. Item number six, I'm assuming Mr. Snyder requested campground project update.
Just very quickly, I did attend a meeting of Mass Historical Commission in Boston on Friday. Our project is one of 16 projects that has gone forward. It is the only archaeological related project granted by the state through this cycle. It's a pretty impressive that we are where we are.
Yes.
We're being supported by the chief or head archaeologist of the state for the writing of the scope of supply for the grant, and we'll be waiting for that to go to the next step. The one thing that was a twist for me and something different that I was not anticipating was that we in fact have to go out to bid for the consultant. And so it's just more, I believe, administrative, but it does kind of slow that process.
The ad was run through us today. Did you put that out today?
No.
Okay.
No, it just, Karen and I went back and forth as to the cost of the ad, probably something in the order of $150 to run the ad. But what that does is that slows us down a little bit to have to go through that process. Where it will probably be August, September-ish, before we actually can do the groundwork. The second, or another piece to this, and probably the important piece is, in our original proposal, we had listed five phases. The first two phases, the acquisition phase and the cleanup phase, were in the process of doing and all good. The next two phases, we broke up into the groundwork and then the documentation. And what the archaeologist is suggesting to us is that in a what we had as a phase five of those next steps, that in fact the proposal will include portions of that where we talk about what preservation restrictions might be possible, what egress may be possible as far as roadways and the like, whether an interpretive site makes any sense to have the consultant in fact provide that kind of information and feedback for us. So it'll change just slightly from what we originally authored in the grant, but good progress.
That's good. Thank you.
Thank you
for going into Boston and doing all of that.
All right, there is no correspondence.
What about the one we talked about in yesterday's meeting, the municipal transfer?
For what?
For the account.
We already voted on it, and the advisory committee.
Oh, they have that already.
Approved it as well.
Okay.
All right. Nothing else. All right. We'll come back to number one, joint meeting with the advisory committee. I'll hold this meeting in recess until everybody's seated, and reconvene after we're all set.
Okay, so I met with Carolyn this morning, and I typed up a very quick, four or five paragraphs of this is Friday morning. So she read it through, and I thought it was a Purple Heart. It's actually a Bronze Star that he was awarded.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a couple things that he met Carolyn after he got back. I thought they were boyfriend and girlfriend before, so I had to fix that.
Because the memorial committee wanted me to get up and not the dedication of the bridge.
No, the other one.
Oh, so why don't we split? Because what I had at the end of it is to...
Yeah,
to
stay, yeah, they wanted... To, yeah,
so
they,
why don't I give you the
I tried to get you at home, Karen.
Sorry to say the bottom of it, but what it was
at
is
home,
it,
but
at the end of what I was going to do for that,
yeah,
and maybe you could do the whole
next opportunity.
I missed
that because they wanted me to do the dedication. They wanted me to talk about
good.
The
good. So have you talked to Becky as far as...
I wasn't.
No, I haven't talked to her about
that. Okay, so Becky and I have been going back and forth because
I had the wrong
gave
Tuesday.
Her kind of a, snapshot of what I was going to say, and she was fine with it.
Okay.
So why don't I do this? Tomorrow I was going to drop off what I had done with Carolyn, and just to make sure she's doubly okay with what I was going to say, what I modified it. What I can do is I can drop a copy here, and what I'll do is I'll mark up, because what I did is
in case I wanted to add anything to it.
Oh, yeah. Because what I tried to do in the last two paragraphs was to say, okay, we're going to do this thing on Saturday, and then we're going to do the bridge dedication, and then we're going to have the memorial service on Sunday, and then it was the last thing that I was reminded of.
What's the other memorial service?
We've done it now for the last 3 years.
Oh, you do it yourself.
Yeah, sure. Yep. And so whether I say that or you can say that, because it's Joe's church. And then the last thing was the bridge.
Yeah, the parade.
And so if you want to do that, we'll split it up.
Yeah, we'll split it up. Yeah, because they kind of thought, because we met down at the bridge the other day, and that's what we were talking about.
This is a special town.
We're going to be working in the morning.
Well, I'm going to be in there
all day. Well, if you want to stop by, do you have another piece of art?
Yeah. What is it? Which one? It's from
special.
In case you guys change the numbers.
I'll be there on Sunday with bells on. Busy Sunday.
You got it over here.
Making repairs. I'd have to ask Steve.
I'm sure it was. I had it, yes, but
not yet.
This is my question.
All right,
see you Sunday.
He's got plenty of time.
I know he did. That's 7 days before, and this is 10th.
We discussed 27 at the last meeting.
So you're going to drop that off then?
Yeah, I'll drop off. What I'll do is I'll stop with Carolyn and double check with her on the whole thing.
Yeah, okay.
And then what I'll do is I'll scratch you take over.
Okay.
I start, you finish.
What did you say you heard was a snafu on the bridge down the bench?
Oh, they were supposed to be fully assembled.
Yeah, but the thing was, because they claimed that, because I went down and they claimed that the surface was still wet and they couldn't do it. So I had seen Michelle, Bunky's wife.
Yeah.
And she says Bunky can take care of that and do the whole thing.
Good.
But I mean, we thought, you know, with what we spent on that bench, the thing would have been complete. But it's really nice because I saw it before we put the tarp on.
All right, welcome back.
There
you go. So you got all copies?
Oh, this is all right.
Yes.
I don't even know if there's enough.
Before we start with the advisory committee, the recommendation again from town council is that we remove Article 39.
Oh, yeah. We already said we would.
So I will entertain a motion to reopen the annual town meeting warrant.
I'll make the motion.
Yep,
second.
Yep.
Any discussion?
Nope.
All in favor?
I'm
going to entertain a motion to remove Article 39 upon town council's request.
Yeah.
He did.
Is there another one?
I'm sorry, what was it?
Oh, yeah, there's.
Oh,
to remove Article 39.
I'll go slow then.
Oh, yeah, there's quite a few copies here.
So we have a motion, we have a second?
Yep.
Any discussion?
Yep. Oh, done.
I don't know if there's another one yet.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion to close the annual town meeting warrant.
I'll make that motion.
And I'll second it.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Our warrants are done.
We decided we'll probably work on that more and then work with Michelle and put it on in the fall.
All right, before we get into the budget, because that's all we have left, right? We don't have to discuss recommendations anymore?
I think
we did have a question because I was talking to Marie about
you got a list.
Number
Twenty-seven. 26 I had okay, so they want to make sure that that didn't feel good. 26 and 27, how does this?
David, Articles 26 and 27. 26 being the 97 Ford to be repaired for $4,700. I think we, I don't have the notes in front of me, but I think we, I think we okayed that one.
I have to wait for that. And the other ones, David said you had to discuss.
Yeah, the $10,000 for the Mack truck.
That was to make for the cash and clean out truck?
Yeah, it's either to repair or replace, repair or purchase, but on the last copy of the, at our last meeting that we looked at, it had X's on it that were not explicit to what it could be spent for. It said rehab the 1980 or
a purchase of used truck.
Or purchase, blah, blah. Well, the thing is, it didn't say specifically.
What article number is that?
To purchase, number
27. Okay.
Okay.
I thought we all approved that.
Well, this is on their end.
Oh, on your end. Oh.
Well, also the draft that you have in front of us, it doesn't state that the Board of Selectmen supported either.
Right, because I was waiting to put the book. Yeah, I didn't put either one on, because those were like questions that you guys said.
And I say that we said.
Actually, yeah.
We approved it.
My notes say that we did take a vote on that.
Yep, both support.
To support it.
Yeah. Okay. What do you support?
Both 26 and 27.
26. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, actually, I think maybe what I was thinking about is the fleet repair replace account.
What what line item is that?
Which one?
Fleet repair
it's
replace.
29.
Not the article, but the line item in the budget.
We did not put a line item in the budget because of the whole concept, and we discussed this during the earlier joint meeting, related to having to raise and appropriate if we put it as a budgetary line item versus having the opportunity to transfer from free cash in order to fund the line.
So you don't have placed. You don't have it anywhere in here?
It is not currently represented in the operational budget.
But we have an account established.
The account is established, correct. But
and you're saying Article 29 funds it.
Article 29.
Did you? Okay, I'm moving ahead of myself. Okay, so did you guys resolve what you needed to resolve?
Yes, we're all set.
And we said we would 81,000 out of free cash.
Well, that's we're getting ahead of ourselves. So,
okay.
You guys are good with the.
We voted for 35,000, and part of the issue that some of us had was the informational line at the bottom of the article says these funds are intended for replacement of police cruiser and XXXXX, and there's no.
Yeah,
okay.
I don't want to entertain that discussion yet. We'll move along with that. Are we good with the warrant? Karen?
So I do have a quick question regarding
on
the
warrant
while it's still open.
Well, it's closed actually.
It's not closed.
I thought you just reopened it to remove.
And we closed it.
And we closed it.
Okay.
Okay, you can see it.
But regardless, what was
okay,
the issue?
So my question related to the warrant, which you may want to consider reopening it, is the same question that I had previously, where I thought that the chair was going to pass on to you, which is
for the
that
annual?
We don't have a final warrant article to address any residual free cash at the end of the meeting to move it to stabilization, which has historically been the method in which we do that. It's a considered almost a standard article like the block articles, okay? And then that way, because currently there is, and it's related to the discussion we just had, there's a bit of a disconnect between where the majority of the advisory committee sits regarding the fleet repair replacement account and where the Board of Selectmen stands for the funds that they feel ought to be placed in that account. And depending on how the voters vote, there's a risk for us to have upwards of $40,000 not allocated during the annual town meeting which if we do not have an article that states we're moving it to stabilization or gives us the opportunity to make the motion to move it to stabilization, that $40,000, instead of going to stabilization where we could access it at need, will have to roll and not be accessible until free cash is certified for FY17.
But a lot of times you leave it in until the fall meeting.
No, we don't.
I think we do.
No, we don't. If we were certifying our free cash, she'd like to have something less than if you had to call a special town meeting before the end of June.
Okay, but that's her typical.
You're pretty passionate about this,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah. I am very passionate about this.
So I'm going to entertain a motion to reopen the annual town meeting warrant.
Sure. Yeah. I'll make that motion.
And I'll second it.
And I will entertain a motion to place Article 42 on. To see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money from free cash to stabilization.
Thank you.
Do I have a motion?
I will make that motion.
Sure, I'll second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Yep, that's why I told them not to. Any other? I will entertain a motion to close.
I'll make a motion to close it.
I'll second.
She shook her head adamantly, so I'm good. All in favor?
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, so we're good with the warrants. Put that to bed. No, that was a special.
No, that was the special.
He didn't do the annual.
He didn't do the regular.
No, he has up.
So I don't know if you want to go advise him of those two changes now. Well, no, because you'd have to make the corrections and email them to him.
Because
he's going to have to wait. He's going to have to wait. He's going to
have
to wait.
Because the annual doesn't have to be posted 7 days before the meeting, and on the special it's 10.
All right, so.
So he's not doing a murder.
My method of madness to the budget line item by line item is to kill the elephant in the room right away, and that's the COLAs. So you guys have decided a 1%. That's what you're recommending. I'm okay with the 1%. I will let the other two speak.
I'd like to go along with 2%.
And I believe from the work that you found out from the schools that I would also recommend 2% an effect on payroll of 2%.
That's where I'm at with my logic of the 1% is because we've been giving the town employees 3% and the schools 2%. So that logic for the schools to the town, it kind of evens back out to the one average wise. And the board has been talking about, you know, COLAs through the feds and whatnot.
Well, I feel that we have to give my feeling is, you know, I sat on this, the employee side all those years, and we would nitpick over our budgets and what we did. And, you know, for many, many years, we never got raises. And I mean, we did good jobs for the people, and all we would get like a little slap on the back and say, oh, you're doing a good job. But I mean, I think we have to give our employees incentives. They all do a very good job.
For how many years we've been given 3%?
Yeah, but I think two. I don't think two is.
So Barbara, do you have the numbers in front of you for the past 5 years, the school versus the town?
Well, the past 3 years is good too.
Oh, 3 years.
Yep.
School versus town.
Yeah, I mean,
we don't have percentages on it. You have the chart, unless it's something
we have. Did we give you this the last time?
You did, but I unfortunately left it in my office in Sturbridge.
What is that, Bob?
It gives you exactly what they've gotten and what they've gotten for raises.
You mean
I
the school?
I thought I passed this off the last time.
No, I didn't get that the last time either.
You gave it to me. I left mine at the office. Mm. I apologize.
I know what the support staff gets.
It shows exactly.
So what have they been getting
their
for the
step
past?
Step and grade, they get two. They get 1.25. 1.5.
Well, that's the support staff.
The support
right?
staff.
The support staff and the teachers got the 1.5 and what is the other one that got?
The teachers got 1.5.
And 1.25 and 1.755.
Yeah.
And how many years back does that go?
Is that last? No, last year.
It's
last
gone
year,
back to.
Can I steal that from you for a second?
Because I know that this year they're all. The teachers are getting two this time, both Tantasqua teachers and the elementary school.
But as previously
when you
stated,
go
the town has gotten
you
three
go,
for a couple of years.
Right,
so.
The past 2 years.
When you go through this and you compare it, you can't compare it to
but you compare it to the teachers and the support staff, and the town has come out
This is just
ahead.
The support staff.
But still, really, though, when you look at their step and grade
it's totally different. But if you look at their payroll check, too, and you check through here, and you see, and they're also, if they're set up in a totally different program than we are.
Oh, I understand that.
And it, like, it's, well, one particular thing that's happening over there this year is if you go and you're going to be in charge of the department, you automatically get a raise.
Is it a raise or a stipend, I think?
But then at the next year, if you don't have that number of students, then you're washed right out again. I mean, you don't have the security over there that you think you've got with these teachers getting their money.
This is just the support staff, and they're getting 4.5% in 3 years.
But this year they're getting 2.25% for their 3 years.
That's fine, Linda, but the last 2 years, if you listen to
the last three years. But I think the teachers got 2.22%.
Yeah, the teachers got 2.22%.
Yeah, that's what I understood.
In Tantasco also. Yeah.
And we gave 3.33%. Mm-hmm. So they're three ahead.
Well, how do you feel, Clarence? Yeah.
I'm into effect on payroll, and my thought was 2%.
Yeah, mine too. Because, with all the articles, if you look at all the articles, we funded all the articles out of free cash.
I know, when we weighed this whole thing up, we looked at what the teachers got, what the support staff got, what the town employees got. We went into what the armed forces got, which was nothing. We went into what the COLAs for Social Security was for nothing for the last 3 years.
The CPI has not gone up.
They have not gotten anything. And if you sit in a meeting and you say, well, they deserve it, nobody is saying that people do not deserve it. I mean, they work hard. But we're running this as a town, just like you, and you can't have people out there in the departments. I get the feeling that you're trying to run the departments as individual contractors. And I think it's time that the town, all employees in the town, all the people that sit on the boards, all the people that put in the time for the rec committee, and they put in tons of time for the kids in this town, receive nothing. They receive nothing for what they do.
I understand.
But now, and I'm not saying that they don't deserve what they get. And they don't deserve maybe more. But the whole thing is, you've got to come to the realization, what can we afford?
So I backpedal, and the word that I heard out of that, and the reason why I'm going with the 1%, is fairness. We have department heads coming to these meetings talking about fairness, equality talk about the school. Mm-hmm. and that fairness when they're getting 2.22% and we're giving 3.33%.
Do you want this one? The other thing that just kind of pops into my head, how we're always talking about planning ahead for the future costs, for this, that, and the other that people want to get done around town. Well, if we keep looking at what is the effect on the budget, granted that's one thing to take into consideration, but when you keep looking at it that way and you're not taking into account how we're never able to put money aside for capital planning, so, I think the 1% says we recognize, that you need some kind of a raise, but you have gotten 3% for a couple of years, and whether or not the budget allows for it, or it has some big effect, I think is almost irrelevant right now, because we're always looking to try to fund other things like trucks and this, that, and the other. Well, we're never going to have any money in the kitty if we keep looking at things that way. Can the budget afford it? Well, sure, can it afford wages? Absolutely. But what about all the other stuff?
Again, that's why I think it should come down on the side of fairness. Beth, have you done an analysis of the school versus town?
I have not done an analysis of school versus the municipal gains.
And I heard you came in at 1.7 versus 1?
I came in at 1.6, but my 1.6 is actually 2%. So what I came in at 1.6 was that if the goal is to provide, one of the things that we tried to communicate to everybody last year, Betty and I were actually trying to communicate the same thing, is that the percent reflected in the budget numbers, because it was a leap year, does not necessarily equate into a wage, directly to the wage increase. So last year we gave a 3% increase, it was reflected as 3.4 from a budget perspective, okay? So that, in essence, that extra 0.4 was baked into the baseline for this year. We could do a budgetary adjustment of 1.6, but with the cooperation of the Board of Selectmen and the Personnel Committee, the wage authorizations could be at 2%. So the overall impact from a budget perspective is 1.6%.
But the line would reflect 1.6.
The line would reflect 1.6, but you could safely make wage authorizations at 2%, provided that people's schedules stayed the same.
And that kind of balances out. Are you guys okay with that? Because it'll show up a 1.6 on it.
Well, yeah.
But theoretically, it'll be the 2%.
Yeah, I mean, that's the answer.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm sorry, but that's the answer.
The answer to what?
I mean, we're at 2 point. I'm talking 2% on effect on payroll. You answered my question by talking about effect on payroll.
Right, so and even at the 1% that the advisory committee is sitting on, it's really a 1.4. It's not really a 1. If you choose to execute it appropriately between the personnel committee and the
board. We're talking a difference of 0.2%?
We're talking a difference of about, well, no, we're talking a difference of 0.4.
0.4.
Basically.
So you're saying then when the personnel board, when we sign things, actually we can go up to 2%?
If we funded it at 1.6,
okay, 1.6.
The wage authorizations could go up 2%. Just people, department heads would need to understand they need to control their hours to that budget.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, and that's I don't see how you can guarantee that.
That's not going to happen.
It's no different than any other year when they get their budget that they're going to.
No, we're playing with numbers now.
Well, it's less of an impact, though, if you're already saying 1% and you already know they're going to go over that, all the more reason to stay at 1%.
What I'm saying is that even at 1%, you could sign the wage authorizations at 1.4, and you will effectively have the budget to do a wage increase of 1.4 at a 1% increase. Likewise, if we went to 1.6, you could do a wage authorization change to 2%, and it would, you know, the funds are there.
But you're still talking about controlling hours.
Right, and that's not going
to
happen.
And that has not proven to be a thing that's manageable.
The only increase in here was the cemetery expense, wasn't it? Municipal transfer.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So to me, they're controlling their.
Yeah.
I'm talking overall overtime.
Well, that's this year, this fiscal year.
Yeah. They're all controlling their
expenses. They're within the budget.
There was no overtime in other departments?
Unbudgeted. Oh,
And
unbudgeted.
Lots of overtime, and they always come back for money during the course of the year when their budgets get short.
Yeah, but that actually hasn't occurred this year.
No.
Well, the only one was the one you guys are about to get was the cemetery commission.
Right.
And that's for.
And that was more of a transfer, though. The cemetery one.
But there was one of them was for overages.
Overages.
So we've kicked this can. What do you want to do?
I think I like Gus' idea. I totally.
Right.
So we're reflecting 1.6 on.
Well, there goodbye's the rub, because we've had the conversation as an advisory committee, and
I still need that vendor to come in.
I think that would be the Board of Health.
That's the Board of Health. Yeah, that's Board of Health.
The Selectmen gave it to me again, but the Selectmen actually.
I've never issued a vendor's license.
The Selectmen actually want me to stop.
Is Mike's
the business?
Is Mike
Mike's in his office still, I believe.
Because no, even the little other one, that like the little trolley car thing he's got, he's never come to us to get a vendor's license. That I think that all comes from the Board of Health.
It didn't then.
It should now, because it's serve safe and all that.
Yeah, I have all that. I just don't have a permit from the Board of Health now, because he's on vacation. I think I run out June 1st, my regular permit. He should be back very soon. So I couldn't set it up now anyway.
Is there any way to work with this gentleman for a vendor's license, or does he have to go somewhere else?
Oh, a vendor's license. Oh, I thought you were talking about permitting.
No, 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 vendor license.
No.
No, you do the course,
though. The vendors?
I've never done a vendor's license.
It's a little pad about this big.
No.
And you fill it up.
We do the food or the mobile vending permit.
That's what that is. It's a mobile.
Oh, yeah. We inspect this cart, and we issue a permit. And
that's a different one. I get that one from the inspector.
Yeah.
The one that town offered.
A vending? I don't ever remember even...
A business certificate? That would be through the town clerk.
No, he gets that from me.
Yeah.
That's entirely different.
So my recommendation is to ask him what he really wants, and if it is on the Board of Selectmen, it's something new to me.
If I'm correct, you just want to set up your mobile cart.
Right, but the town wanted me to have a vendor. I had to come in here.
Well, it won't be on town through... And Clarence, have you made up your mind? This is still in the air. Are we going to continue?
No, I'm clear with you.
Yeah,
as far
I am
not
too.
On town land.
Yeah.
So unanimously, we're not going to allow him to set up on town property.
Okay.
So he still has the ability to set up on private property, but he's looking for licensing to do that.
I recall what you went through before regarding this vending. For some reason, you had to come back. Am I correct? You came before this board one
yes,
at a time?
For this permit.
Maybe another board.
Yeah, this was during another...
Yeah, it was good for a year.
Yeah.
Came from the town, was signed by the selectman.
Don Nealon was here at that time. I remember this issue because for some reason he was sent here. What prompted that back in that time? I forget. It was just some unusual circumstance that came up. You'd been in business for some time.
Someone
issued permits from us, but this was something entirely different.
Exactly. I'd been doing this for years at a racetrack in Connecticut, and when I set up over here, at the West Brookfield town line, someone from the town saw me there and came in and said, we just can't have someone set up anywhere and whatever they want, whether it is. And immediately I was told to stop work until the next selectman's meeting to come in and get a permit.
Can you bring a copy of that to our administrative assistant tomorrow?
I might have it, but it's just a piece of paper. It didn't even cost anything. But
if you can bring that to the town, acknowledging the fact that I had the right to.
That was between 2007 and 2009.
Could
be. In fact, I probably got some old emails in regards to the situation because it went back and forth between Jeff Taylor and the zoning enforcement officer. I'll do some research.
Okay, and then we'll just work on that.
Yeah, Jimmy Allen, that's how long
ago.
Sure.
Yeah, a long time ago.
Now, you have your state vendors.
Which would have been expired by now.
Yeah.
You have the state.
Yeah, I have all that. I have my state served. I have an inspection. They've inspected my kitchen inside. They've inspected my storage area outside and my cooking area outside, my freezers, and I'm good to go. I just wanted to run it by you guys to set up there.
Well, we're not discouraging from private property, so if you need anything from us, let us know.
Okay.
Yeah, right?
And Michael will research that permit, I guess.
And like I said, if you have a copy of that, if you can
bring
it in.
Look, I keep most of my stuff, so I probably can't.
Okay.
And then we can research what they did.
Okay. Yeah, it didn't even cost anything. It just was
A piece of paper that they made you jump through
hoops. Yeah, they made
it. Cost of the printing.
Yeah.
Right, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Item number 5, municipal relief transfer. There's 2 requests. Hasn't made it before the advisory committee, but make it through us tonight if you'd like. First request is from Michael Seri, Cemetery Commission. Requesting a transfer of $1,685 from cemetery payroll to perpetual care. Only $892 remaining in the account at this time. Used last wages during same time last year to determine what will be needed to get through the remainder of the year. Entertain a motion to approve transfer.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
For Michael Seri as well, a request for $1,050 from the Board of Health expense to the transfer station expense. Earlier in the fiscal year, Chairman Leahy successfully completed the Mass Title V Soil Evaluator Certificate class. Board agreed to reimburse Dan for his training. After he got a certificate, we anticipated a shortage. I'm basically requesting that $1,050 to cover it. Entertain a motion for municipal relief transfer.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Mm-hmm. A copy of Dan's.
Mm-hmm. I just wanted to get that amount. Mm-hmm.
give that to the chair before they leave tonight. Maybe they can act on it tonight. Item number six, I'm assuming Mr. Snyder requested campground project update.
Just very quickly, I did attend a meeting of Mass Historical Commission in Boston on Friday. Our project is one of 16 projects that has gone forward. It is the only archaeological related project granted by the state through this cycle. So pretty impressive that we are where we are. We're being supported by the chief or head archaeologist of the state for the writing of the scope of supply for the grant, and we'll be waiting for that to go to the next step. The one thing that was a twist for me is something different that I was not anticipating was that we in fact have to go out to bid for the consultant. And so it's just more, I believe, administrative, but it does kind of slow that process.
The ad was run through us today. Did you put that out today?
No.
Okay.
No, it just, Karen and I went back and forth as to the cost of the ad. It probably something in the order of $150 to run the ad. Okay. But what that does is that slows us down a little bit to have to go through that process. Where it will probably be August, September-ish, before we actually can do the groundwork. The second, or another piece to this, and probably an important piece, is in our original proposal we had listed five phases. The first two phases, the acquisition phase and the cleanup phase, we're in the process of doing, and all good. The next two phases we broke up into the groundwork and then the documentation. And what the archaeologist is suggesting to us is that in what we had as a phase five of those next steps, that in fact the proposal will include portions of that where we talk about what preservation restrictions might be possible, what egress may be possible as far as roadways and the like, whether an interpretive site makes any sense to have the consultant in fact provide that kind of information and feedback for us. So it'll change just slightly from what we originally authored in the grant, but good progress.
That's good. Thank you for going into Boston doing all of that.
All right, there is no correspondence.
What about the one we talked about in yesterday's meeting, the municipal transfer?
For what?
For the account.
We already voted on it, and the advisory committee.
Oh, they have that already. Okay.
Approved it as well.
Okay.
All right. Nothing else? All right, we'll come back to number one, joint meeting with the advisory committee. I'll hold this meeting in recess until everybody's seated and reconvene after we're all set. All right, welcome back.
There you go. So you got all copies?
Oh, this is all right.
Yes.
There are
not. I don't even know if there's enough.
Before we start with the advisory committee, the recommendation to Gil again from town council is that we remove Article 39.
Oh, yeah. We already said we would.
So I will entertain a motion to reopen the annual town meeting warrant.
I'll make the motion.
Yep,
second.
Yep.
Any discussion?
Nope.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'm going to entertain a motion to remove Article 39 upon town council's request.
Yeah.
He did. All four, no.
Is there another one?
I'm sorry, what was it?
Oh, yeah, there's...
Oh.
To remove Article 39.
I'll go slow then.
Oh, yeah, there's quite a few copies here.
So do we have a motion? We have a second?
Yep.
Make any discussion?
Yep. Oh, done.
I don't know if there's another one yet.
Yeah. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion to close the annual town meeting
warrant.
I'll
make that motion.
And I'll second it.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Our warrants are done.
We decided we'll probably work on that more and then work with Michelle and put it on in the fall.
All right, before we get into the budget, because that's all we have left, right? We don't have to discuss recommendations anymore?
I think, we did have a question because I was talking to Marie about
Articles 26 and 27. 26 being the 97 Ford to be repaired for $4,700. I think we okayed that.
I have to pay for that. And the other ones, David said you had to discuss.
Yeah, the $10,000 for the Mack truck.
That was to make for the basin cleanout truck?
Yeah, it's either to repair or replace, repair or purchase, but on the last copy of the, at our last meeting that we looked at, it had X's on it that were not explicit to what it could be spent for. It said rehab the 1980 or
a purchase of used truck.
Or purchase, blah, blah. Well, the thing is, it didn't say specifically.
What article number is that?
To purchase number 20.
27. Okay.
Okay.
So,
I thought we all approved that.
Well, this is on their end.
Oh, on your end.
Well, also the draft that you have in front of us, it doesn't state that the Board of Selectmen is going to be there.
Right, because I was waiting to put, well, yeah, I didn't put up either one because those two had questions, but you guys said I just.
And I say that we said.
Actually, yeah.
We approved it.
My notes say that we did take a vote on that.
Yep, both support.
We support it.
Yeah. Okay. Do you support?
Both 26 and 27.
26. Yes.
Yeah.
Actually, I think maybe what I was thinking about is the fleet repair replace account.
What what line item is that?
Which one?
Fleet repair replace.
29.
Not the article, but the line item in the budget.
We did not put a line item in the budget because of the whole concept, and we discussed this during the earlier joint meeting, related to having to raise and appropriate if we put it as a budgetary line item versus having the opportunity to transfer to free cash in order to fund the line.
So you don't have it anywhere in here?
It is not currently represented in the operational budget.
But we have an account established.
The account is established, correct.
But and you're saying Article 29 funds it.
Article 29.
I'm moving ahead of myself. Okay, so did you guys resolve what you needed to resolve?
Yes, we're all set.
And we said we would 81,000 out of free cash.
Well, that's we're getting ahead of ourselves. So, okay. You guys are good with it.
We voted for 35,000, and part of the issue that some of us had was the informational line at the bottom of the article says these funds are intended for replacement of police cruiser and XXXXX.
I don't want to entertain that discussion yet. We'll move along with that. Are we good with the warrant? Karen?
So I have a quick question regarding
on the warrant
while it's still open.
Well, it's closed, actually.
It's not closed.
I thought you just reopened it to remove it.
And we closed it.
And we closed it.
Okay, you can see it.
But regardless, what was the issue?
So my question related to the warrant, which you may want to consider reopening it, is the same question that I had previously, where I thought that the CEO was going to pass on to you, which
for
is
the
that
annual?
We don't have a final warrant article to address any residual free cash at the end of the meeting to move it to stabilization, which has historically been the method in which we do that. It's a considered almost a standard article like the block articles, okay? And then that way, because currently there is, and it's related to the discussion we just had, there's a bit of a disconnect between where the majority of the advisory committee sits regarding the fleet repair replacement account and where the Board of Selectmen stands for the funds that they feel ought to be placed in that account. And depending on how the voters vote, there's a risk for us to have upwards of $40,000 not allocated during the annual town meeting, which if we do not have an article that states we're moving it to stabilization or gives us the opportunity to make the motion to move it to stabilization, that $40,000, instead of going to stabilization where we could access it at need, will have to roll and not be accessible until free cash is certified for FY17.
But a lot of times you leave it in until the fall meeting.
No, we don't.
I think we do.
No, we don't. If we were certifying our free cash
Always told me she'd like to have something.
She'd like to have something less than if you had to call a special town meeting before the end of June.
Okay, but that's her typical.
You're pretty passionate about this, huh?
I am very passionate about this.
So I'm going to entertain a motion to reopen the annual town meeting warrant.
Sure.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
And I will entertain a motion to place Article 42 on, to see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money from free cash to stabilization.
Thank you.
Do I have a motion?
I will make that motion.
Sure, I'll second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Yep, that's why I told them not to. Any other, I will entertain a motion to close.
I'll make a motion to close it.
I'll second.
She shook her head adamantly, so I'm good. All in favor?
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, okay, so we're good with the warrants, put that to bed. No, that was a special.
No, that was the special.
He didn't do the annual.
He didn't do the regular one.
No, he has up.
So I don't know if you want to go advise him of those two changes now, well, no, because you'd have to make the corrections and email them to him.
Because see.
He's going to have to wait.
Because the annual doesn't have to be posted 7 days before the meeting, and on the special is 10.
All right, so.
So he's not doing them.
My method of madness to the budget line item by line item is to kill the elephant in the room right away, and that's the COLAs. So you guys have decided a 1%, that's what you're recommending. I'm okay with the 1%, I will let the other two speak.
I'd like to go along with 2%.
And I believe from the work that you found out from the schools that I would also recommend 2% or an effect on payroll of 2%.
That's where I'm at with my logic of the 1% is because we've been giving the town employees 3% and the schools 2%. So that logic for the schools to the town, it kind of evens back out to the one average-wise. And the board has been talking about COLAs through the feds and whatnot.
Well, I feel that we have to give my feeling is, I sat on this, the employee side all those years, and we would nitpick over our budgets and what we did. And, for many, many years, we never got raises. And I mean, we did good jobs for the people, and all we would get like a little slap on the back and say, oh, you're doing a good job. But I mean, I think we have to give our employees incentives. They all do a very good job.
For how many years have we been given 3%?
Yeah, but I think two. I don't think two is.
So, Barbara, do you have the numbers in front of you for the past 5 years, the school versus the town?
Well, the past 3 years is good, too.
Well, 3 years.
Yeah.
School versus town?
Yeah, I mean.
You have to try, unless there's something.
Did we give you this the last time?
You did, but I unfortunately left it in my office in Sturbridge.
What is that, Bob?
It gives you exactly what they've gotten and what they've gotten for raises.
You mean
the
school?
I thought I passed this off the last time.
No, I didn't get that the last time either.
You gave it to me. I left mine at the office. I apologize.
I know what the support staff's getting.
It shows exactly.
So what have they been getting for the past?
Step and grade, they get two. They get 1.25. 1.5.
Well, that's the support staff,
the
right?
Support staff.
The support staff and the teachers got the 1.5, and what is the other one that got?
The teachers got 1.5?
And 1.25 and 1.75.
Yeah.
And how many years back does that go?
Is that last year?
It's gone back to.
Can I steal that from you for a second?
Because I know that this year they're all, the teachers are getting two this time, both Tantasqua teachers and the elementary school.
But as previously stated, the town has gotten three for a couple of years.
Right, the past 2 years.
When you go through this and you compare it, you can't compare it to, but you compare it to the teachers and the support staff.
Yes,
and the town has come out.
This is just
ahead.
The support staff.
But still, really though, when you look at their step and grade it's totally different.
Yeah, but if you look at their payroll check too, and you check through here and you see, and they're also, if they're set up in a totally different program than we are.
Oh, I understand
and it's Well, one particular thing that's happening over there this year is if you go and you're going to be in charge of the department, you automatically get a raise.
Is it a raise or a stipend, I think?
But then at the next year, if you don't have that number of students, then you're washed right out again. I mean, you don't have the security over there that you think you've got with these teachers getting their money.
This is just the support staff, and they're getting 4.5% in 3 years.
But this year, they're getting 2.25% for their 3 years.
That's fine, Linda, but the last 2 years, if you listen to
the last 3 years. But I think the teachers got 2.22%.
Yeah, the teachers got 2.22%.
Yeah, that's what I understood.
In Tantasco also.
And we gave 3.33%. So they're 3 ahead.
Well, how do you feel, Clarence, on it?
I'm into effect on payroll, and my thought was 2%.
Yeah, mine too. Because, with all the articles, if you look at all the articles, we funded all the articles out of free cash.
When we weighed this whole thing up, we looked at what the teachers got, what the support staff got, what the town employees got. We went into what the armed forces got, which was nothing. We went into what the COLAs for Social Security was for nothing for the last 3 years.
The CPI has not gone up.
They have not gotten anything. And if you sit in a meeting and you say, well, they deserve it, they deserve it, they deserve it, nobody is saying that people do not deserve it. I mean, they work hard. But we're running this as a town, just like you, and you can't have people out there in the departments. I get the feeling that you're trying to run the departments as individual contractors. And I think it's time that the town, all employees in the town, all the people that sit on the boards, all the people that put in the time for the rec committee, and they put in tons of time for the kids in this town, receive nothing. They receive nothing for what they do.
I understand.
But now, and I'm not saying that they don't deserve what they get. And they don't deserve maybe more. But the whole thing is, you've got to come to the realization, what can we afford?
So I backpedal, and the word that I heard out of that, and the reason why I'm going with the 1%, is fairness. We have department heads coming to these meetings talking about fairness, equality talk about the school. Mm-hmm. And that fairness when they're getting 2.22% and we're giving 3.33%.
Do you want this one? The other thing that just kind of pops into my head, how we're always talking about planning ahead for the future costs, for this, that, and the other that people want to get done around town. Well, if we keep looking at what is the effect on the budget, granted that's one thing to take into consideration, but when you keep looking at it that way and you're not taking into account how we're never able to put money aside for capital planning, so, I think the 1% says we recognize, that you need some kind of a raise, but you have gotten 3% for a couple of years, and whether or not the budget allows for it, or it has some big effect, I think is almost irrelevant right now, because we're always looking to try to fund other things like trucks and this, that, and the other. Well, we're never going to have any money in the kitty if we keep looking at things that way. Can the budget afford it? Well, sure, can it afford wages? Absolutely. But what about all the other stuff?
Again, that's why I think it should come down on the side of fairness. Beth, have you done an analyzation of the school versus town?
I have not done an analysis of school versus municipal gains.
And I heard you came in at 1.7 versus 1?
I came in at 1.6. But my 1.6 is actually 2%. So what I came in at 1.6 was that if the goal was to provide, one of the things that we tried to communicate to everybody last year, Betty and I were actually trying to communicate the same thing, is that the percent reflected in the budget numbers, because it was a leap year, does not necessarily equate into a wage, directly to the wage increase. So last year we gave a 3% increase it was reflected is 3.4 from a budget perspective. Okay, so that in essence, that extra 0.4 was baked into the baseline for this year. We could do a budgetary adjustment of 1.6, but with the cooperation of the Board of Selectmen and the Personnel Committee, the wage authorizations could be at 2%. So the overall impact from a budget perspective is 1.6%.
But the line would reflect 1.6.
The line would reflect 1.6, but you could safely make wage authorizations at 2%, provided that people's schedules stayed the same.
And that kind of balances out. Are you guys okay with that? Because it'll show up a 1.6 on it.
Well, theoretically,
it'll be the 2%.
Yeah, I mean, that's the answer.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm sorry, but that's the answer.
The answer to what?
We're at 2 point. I'm talking 2% on effect on payroll. You answered my question by talking about effect on payroll.
Right, so and even at the 1% that the advisory committee is sitting on, it's really a 1.4. It's not really a 1. If you choose to execute it appropriately between the personnel committee and the
board. So we're talking a difference of 0.2%?
We're talking a difference of about, well, no, we're talking a difference of 0.4.
0.4.
Basically.
So you're saying then when the personnel board, when we sign things, actually we can go up to 2%?
If we funded it at 1.6,
okay, 1.6.
The wage authorizations could go up 2%. Just department heads would need to understand they need to control their hours to that budget.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, and that's I don't see how you can guarantee that.
That's not going to happen.
It's no different than any other year when they get their budget that they're going to.
No, we're playing with numbers now.
Well, it's less of an impact, though, if you're already saying 1% and you already know they're going to go over that, all the more reason to stay at 1%.
What I'm saying is that even at 1%, you could sign the wage authorizations at 1.4, and you will effectively have the budget to do a wage increase of 1.4 at a 1% increase. Likewise, if we went to 1.6, you could do a wage authorization change to 2%, and it would, you know, the funds are there.
But you're still talking about controlling hours.
Right, and that's not going to happen.
And that has not proven to be a thing that's manageable.
The only increase in here was the cemetery expense, wasn't it? Municipal transfer.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So to me, they're controlling their...
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm talking overall overtime.
Well, that's this year, this fiscal year.
Yeah, they're all controlling their expenses.
They're within the budget.
There was no overtime in other departments?
Unbudgeted.
Unbudgeted. Lots of overtime, and they always come back for money during the course of the year when their budgets get short.
Yeah, but that actually hasn't occurred this year.
No.
Well, the only one was the one you guys are about to get was the cemetery commission.
Right. And that's for...
And that was more of a transfer, though, the cemetery one.
But it was one of them was for overages.
Overages.
So we've kicked this can. What do we want to do?
I think I like this idea. Totally.
Mm, right.
So we're reflecting 1.6 on the.
Well, there goodbye's the rub because we've had the conversation as an advisory committee, and regardless of where. I personally stand as what I feel the appropriate number is to go in the book. The vote of the committee is that the number that the advisory committee recommends is 1%. And that's what goes in the book.
Technically, the Board of Selectmen puts out the book. We've had that discussion because we didn't want five different figures on the floor.
But it's our book.
Yes.
That's what we did last year. It was showed as 3%. You guys didn't vote on a 3%. And it reflected a 3% in the book.
Right, and last year I changed the column per a very last minute conversation to state that it was the Board of Selectmen's recommendation. There's a significant amount of feedback from the community that they expect the recommendation in the book to be from the advisory committee, because it's the advisory committee that publishes the...
And I'd ask you to reconsider your fight on the floor, your thoughts on the article that we're presenting, because it specifically states that you turn the budget over to the selectmen and we put it out to the people of Brookfield to alleviate this discussion.
Well, it's like turning into a little bit of a different conversation, because you're saying we do the budget, but then we hand it over to you, and then you guys get to do whatever you want with it. in the end, which kind of makes us feel like, what are we doing all this for?
Now, we don't want to look like a bunch of folks that don't necessarily have our ducks in a row.
We want to be in
agreement. Town meeting. There's a couple of alternatives that we have to make it evident that there's an alternate Board of Selectmen budget from a purely kind of publishing perspective, okay? If you wanted either a block segment of what the line deltas are for the Board of Selectmen's alternate budget and put a hold on the line items that that applies to, at least then it's clear that that's the alternative and we have very clear-cut alternatives.
And we have to have a dozen holds to play
right,
a game.
And that's what we're going to do.
So can we collectively think of a number right now so we don't have to play a game on town floor?
Well, my board said 1%, so. And we're all talking about fairness, and the employees are always talking about what the school's getting, okay?
Yeah.
So now here we are. They got more last year for 2 years at 3%, and now here we are. They're still ahead of the game, and you want to go more, again, for the employees than the school got.
So if we took a vote and we did a majority rule here between both boards, we'd come 4-4. Are we okay if I come back to 1% and print what the advisory committee is suggesting, the 1%? And then if you want to put holds on it, we'll put holds on it. And I won't argue it on the floor. But I want to see one book go out. I don't want to see... You weren't here for that year. That was a horrible year.
Oh, that was terrible.
The accountant had one. Beth had one. I had one.
There was other people that had them out there.
It was awful.
That was
the board had a couple of different, we were changing, and there was a lot of interchanging back then.
So getting back to effect on payroll, the 1%, does that translate to 1%? Or because of the
leap
year, does that translate to something different?
It translates to whatever you, the department heads, and the personnel board choose to translate it to.
As long as it's in the budget.
Right. So if we vote 1%, if you choose as entities that are controlling that budget to give everybody a 1.4% raise, you have the budget to do.
Only because that 0.4 is already baked in.
Because that 0.4 is baked in the base.
Okay, so
unless we published a budget at 0.6% raise, that money is
which would make it effectively 1%.
Correct.
At the end.
Right.
So we're talking.
It's kind of confusing.
Yeah, I'm kind of a leap. I'm kind of confused with this too.
Basically, there's an extra day of pay already baked into the budget.
Right. So what I'm saying is, you're really, if we get out of this hours of operation and people working to their budget, you're talking, you're at a 1.4% point. Mm-hmm. And my position was that I was saying 2%, but you informed me of the leap year thing. So that's really 1.6%.
Correct.
So where I come back again is that we're talking about this for 0.2%.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
In that respect, yes. We're saying 1% is 1% is 1%.
That's it.
So we're taking, that includes, our 1% includes that 0.4 that's already in there.
Well, that 0.4 is for this fiscal year. That 1%, it would have to come before this board through the personnel at 1% on paper to give them a 1% raise.
That's correct.
What they're saying is that there's enough money in there to technically give them a 1.4% raise if they don't go over anything. So it would have to come across our desk at a 1.4. It's voted on the town floor at 1. There's enough money in there to give them a 1.4.
And that's to our discretion.
If the money's there and if we trust the department heads to manage their payroll.
As they have been doing.
Correct.
But if the town people vote 1%, it's got to be 1%
They're voting the line. They're not voting the person's wage rate.
They're voting the money in that account, Dave.
I don't think people realize
that's where the problem is,
It will be discussed on the floor adamantly, I'm assuming.
We explained it last year the same way. that it was gonna be only a 3% raise because everybody went 3.4. And it's like, no, really, it's 3%.
So do you understand?
I'm kind of getting it.
I'm understanding more now, too.
And so where I'm headed is this 2/10 of a percent that I'm talking about. What kind of money are we talking?
Not even. It's for each 1% change on the wages we're talking about, which does not include, just to understand the wages we're talking about. I have to double check if I rolled in. I didn't roll in EMT into the overall delta because that's funded out of ambulance receipts. But if you're talking just what's funded out of raise and appropriate, less the school, less the police, okay? Less this year fire, because the next hot topic we probably have is the wage adjustment that we're recommending for the individual.
We're going to hit that on the line item.
Right. Mm-hmm. It's about a $7,000 per percent bottom line cost of the town for everybody's raise. And we went through line by line because nobody trusted the spreadsheet.
That also doesn't count the school. Did you say that?
I did. No. I said it doesn't count the school, it doesn't count the police, it doesn't count EMT, and this year it does not include the firefighters.
So the discussion here is what's going to be printed in the book, mm-hmm. and not to have a fight between both boards on the town floor. They want to print the one. If we did a democracy type vote on all of us, mm-hmm. it would kind of be a 4-4 vote. And I would take the tiebreaker and come back to the 1%. So do we want to print one? Do you want to convince me to go the other way and print 1.6?
If he hasn't convinced you by now.
He hasn't.
Okay.
But I'm trying to get a win-win here for you guys to buy in with the one so we're not fighting
now
on the floor.
Now, you said the overall raises were what, 7,000?
Yeah, it's about 7,000.
8%. We're talking so
per percent.
Per percent.
Per percent of salary budget, excluding the groups that
That's what you told us,
It's $7,000 per.
So we're talking about
And not out of disrespect, I'm parked over on the fairness of the teachers versus the town in the past 3 years.
I understand.
Yeah.
And we've run that.
And I've never argued the 3% raise for the past 3 or 4 years that the town's come before us and asked for it.
So and your point there is that we've run the gamut. The threes were the threes. The twos were the twos.
Theirs were the
twos.
You
think that, and again, I would ask the advisory board for concurrence of that.
But they're best saying that they didn't run those numbers. They're doing it on the COLAs of the federal government, which is zero.
Right. We did not run it against the school. We did not consciously run the percentage against the school, though.
But back to the fairness argument.
Well, we did and we didn't. We went over everything. The school, what the military was getting, what the feds were, everything.
And feds is a true cost of living.
We went through everything.
We're not talking about cost of living increases. We're talking about a pay raise.
Right.
Cost of living is at the Social Security level.
There's a piece of merit and there's a piece that's not.
Yeah.
And
this is not a merit. Okay, so what do you call a COLA? It's a cost of living, which the federal government has decided
to zero. So, and that's semantics, but that's been fought for a decade in this town. I'm just bringing that to light. So to me, this is merit. It's a merit raise.
No, it's not a merit raise.
Well, that's what it boils down to because there's no other reason to get this.
Okay, you want to call it that way? You can do it that way. I guess you could call it that, but
It is. It is what it is.
I guess it is, yeah. If all CPI is zero,
it's zero.
That's what you're saying.
So they're getting 1% increase. So we're giving them something for appreciation, and if you want to call it a merit, I guess you could call it that.
So we've kicked it where we're keeping it.
I think this is a very, very hard subject.
100%.
It's a very hard one because you don't want people to feel you don't think you're worth it. But at the same time,
I'll never forget. I had an employee, and it sticks with me. My assumption was I was paying him good money. I paid him every week. He did his job, and he said, "You know what, Steve? It'd be nice to come up to me and say once in a while, 'Good job, Tim.'" And that stuck with me.
It's true.
I think this town does pretty good by giving the town employees some. Some towns don't give anything. Some years they don't get anything in some towns.
So are we good with one, or do we want to fight it on the floor, or...
I think we should go on as a united force, all of us settling at the same thing, but I know it's going to get changed on the town floor.
That's at the discretion of the town meeting.
Right, that's fine.
Which is the reason why I landed on 1.6, because I think you can make an argument if people want to see a 2% raise, we can budget it at 1.6 and have a much shorter evening.
And that's where I was at.
It's not going to be a short evening.
No, this might be a two-nighter.
I think we should plan for a two-nighter personally, looking at that warrant. That's just
at the discretion.
I am not an optimist.
That's at the discretion of the moderator. So we good with one, United Front, 1%? With the understanding that it's a 1.4, theoretically, if it's managed correctly.
And that has to be explained.
Yes, that has to be explained.
All right, so that's the elephant in the room. It's shot, it's buried.
1%.
Well, I don't know if it's buried.
Well, in this discussion, it is.
It might be resurrected.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be.
That'll be a June 10th. That'll be a June 10th resurrection.
I always hate this part of the budget.
All right, so the first page, I don't know where we want to place it, but archiving, we've had this discussion. I don't know if you were brought. We had this discussion.
We have not had that discussion.
So you haven't had the discussion. We've been advised that it's a law that we have to archive.
Yep.
We're not doing it. Tantasqua is going to charge way too much. We've gone out to two places. Microsoft is $3,060 yearly. And then what Tantasqua and our web designer and Tom George is recommending is Virtual Town Hall. There's an upfront cost of $5,000 and then $1,800 per year. I'm not sure, and it backs up the emails.
And virtual town hall, I know a lot of communities are doing virtual town hall.
So I don't know if the $5,000 includes the first 1 year, $1,800. I'm assuming we'd have to budget $6,800 in case it doesn't, but it's not really defined in here. So I'm going to request an additional $7,000 for this.
And which line?
That's where I'm asking you guys where you want to put it. And that'd be strictly for archiving.
Since it's over $5,000, I know you don't want to reopen it, probably, but do you want to just vote it?
I would put it in the budget.
And where would we put it?
So it's for the website, for all intents and purposes, correct? Because if we went to the virtual town hall, it would be a complete redesign that we looked at a number of years ago for a more accessible website. Quick question for anybody associated with the Master Planning Committee. One of the things on their agenda was upgrade of the website.
But they're not going to get to that for months, if anything. I mean, back to priority and stuff, I wouldn't think they'd get
it. So what line are you going to put this in?
Probably
90?
I would say.
90. I would go with that.
So we're going to put it up to $7,000?
$9,000? Or no, actually, if it includes the hosting, do you know what the timeline would be for implementation of the virtual town hall?
Probably have to get some more info on that. But I know the
info that we need to deal with tonight is the dollar amount.
So let's budget at $7,000 and if we have to revisit it at the special because we had some time where we had to maintain it on the old system, we could deal with that.
So increase line number 90 to 9,000?
So how much did they request?
We have $2,000 already requested. So we want to add another $7,000, so we'd want to...
Why is it adding another $7,000? Because if you're going to move to the virtual town hall, you're no longer going to have the web hosting expense,
how long
correct?
It take to do, I don't know.
How much are you requesting right now to do this email?
I don't know anything about the website. I know that...
They're saying $6,800, so I'm rounding it to $7,000.
Okay, all right.
And then there was a request prior for that line for $2,000, so 7 plus 2 is 9. Talk me out of not doing the whole...
So actually the email archiving would, from a standpoint of where it belongs more under computer security than it does on the website. Now, if we go to virtual town hall, that belongs under website. So if we're saying that the archiving alone takes what, how much of that funds?
I think it's all rolled into it, the whole thing.
I'd put it on the line 50. Selectmen expenses, that's what I would do.
No, you don't want to put it there.
Catch one. It's like a catch
one. Yeah.
I would bump it to the 9,000 to line item 90.
90. Yeah, that's where I'd put it to.
And like we said, we can run the numbers and then switch it to special in the fall if we have to.
Okay. going to back it off if it gets changed, if it gets changed up or lineup, so we need to keep an eye on the execution. Who's going to project manage getting it, getting the switch turned?
Tom.
Our website to that.
I'm hoping that Tom George, since we already have him built in to help us.
And he's familiar with it.
Yes, and he's the one that also recommended it.
So worst case, if Tom doesn't do it, it'll be Tantasco.
I see one to 9,000, Steve.
No, we said seven.
I'd like to see line item 90 to be a total of $9,000.
$9,000, okay.
You understand that?
I'll make a motion to rebuild line 90 at $9,000.
Someone want to second that?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, so line by line, if we have any questions.
So we don't have anything here seeing what the, this is a, now all these recommendations that you have on here, is this basically what the departments wanted, or is this your recommendation?
That's our recommendation.
This is what we recommended and what we found out.
So we don't see, anything of what they want.
I was instructed by the balance of the board to remove the department submission line.
What's that?
I have this.
So what?
I don't have what you have. Mine is different.
Where did you go?
All right, number.
See, I don't have them all.
Have all what?
So, and I may have sent out one that didn't have the columns hidden, so that's probably my bad.
This is the one I have.
The balance of the advisory committee.
I have the one that just.
This one does say department request.
I don't have that.
I have department.
Yeah, it says department request, what?
No, I'll show you the one I.
You probably have the one from last meeting.
That's the one. Did I?
I'll make a copy.
You put a new one in the box?
Yeah, you can get it in the box.
Oh, because you told me you wanted to know if I needed one. Oh, okay, I didn't know.
Listen, we requested not to have this impact. This is the one you gave us tonight, okay? We, as a board, we don't want 20 lines in this budget, and that's what the board decided. We're not going to put what the department requested. We asked just the way what we recommended.
I thought we were talking about, that's something we talked about last week, to see.
Well, that can be your discretion. For this discussion, I think it's good in this format.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Yes, I think we need to see what was recommended.
Yeah, because you should, we asked.
I probably unhit it when I was doing the calculations with the.
So it's just going to get too confusing when we get to the town meeting, Steve.
Before it goes out to print, that's your discretion, but for tonight's conversation, I think it's a good thing.
Oh, yeah.
It's not going to make much difference.
Karen's going to get those for you, too.
Yeah.
Did you get both, Karen? Clarence, did you take yours out of your box?
Yeah, I did. Okay. Yeah.
Because my understanding, when you called me, I thought.
Yes, but what happened is since then I.
Okay, that's why there's another one.
Updated version.
Okay, all right. All righty, because I did. Thank you.
All right, so my first question is 30.
So why don't we go back here to 90?
Why is there an increase from request?
Oh, because originally, and that may actually be an error, originally we were looking at boiling the town accountant clerk into standard municipal clerk wages. We didn't want to establish a secondary line.
So
we definitely
got put in assistant wages, though, on this. It got put in 30 instead of 40. According to
this is the administrative assistant, not the clerk.
Right.
Administrative assistant has a 1% increase.
For what purpose?
Administrative assistant, the COLA?
Yeah, the 1%. Everybody got a 1%.
Oh, you already included the 1% in here?
Yeah. And the one that you received that I sent to Karen, like, either late last night or
Okay, I didn't know that.
Oh, so this one.
It had the 1%.
Oh, this one has the 1%.
That answers my question.
Because it's wages.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
It was wages, and I had put the 1% in.
All right.
So, Selectmen Municipal Clerk Wage, do you have a line item for town account? You do, for clerk.
Yeah, so actually, no, on this one, I did it exactly. Actually, for some reason, I don't have the COLA baked into that line, so I missed that.
But that's fine. At least it's in there.
Yeah, so I'm going to fix the formula while I'm in there.
So municipal clerk wages doesn't have the 1%?
No.
Line 40, right?
Yeah. So that goes to 10,590 with the correction.
All right, computer maintenance was decreased from request. line 80?
We had that discussion jointly where you thought you were going to have to replace a number of computers, but that you haven't actually gone through the maintenance budget yet this year, so it looked like it would be a good place to
cut.
Cut.
All right.
Okay.
Anybody else have any questions on the first page?
And that $2,000 shows up in the Selectmen computer acquisition, so it was a one for one.
Okay.
You put the, we don't have a 1% on 205, because that's a new line item.
Yeah, there's no 1% in 205, because it's a new line item.
Okay, now, weren't we going to change, we're going to leave town accountant there at...
Well, I didn't want to make that change yet, in case, like, I don't know that we had identified that if we wind up paying any type of service, or if we wind up... You know, what you set that wage at, we can always do the adjustment at the special.
And now what is this, and now how many hours is the clerk based on?
I thought the clerk amount was like $6,700.
Because we decided to go...
Ten was seven, and we voted for five, which this is before the town accountant left.
Mm-hmm.
And then we brought it down to $3,500, thereabouts.
Right, but then I thought we took it back up because of the fact that we had talked about restructuring the accountant's office to...
20 and 15.
To 20 and 15. So that 10,000 is at 15.
Is it? Okay.
But I think the intent was if we were going to do that, then I do need to take that town accountant salary number down some.
I think we need to take it down if we're advertising for 20 hours and someone pulls it up.
Yeah.
For what got voted, they're gonna kind of want to demand.
So that was based off of what, 36 hours?
Yes, that's what we've been told.
Yeah.
That's what she's supposed to be currently working, or was working.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how many hours are you planning on having a clerk for the town accountant is what we need to know for sure.
10 hours for a clerk, 20 hours for a accountant.
I thought we said 15 for a clerk.
Go 15.
15, that's what was advised by
the auditor. At the same rate that... The person was getting before.
Correct.
Okay.
And I have that at and the way I did the calculation for the $10,140 was $13.
Yep.
Times 30, which is 2 weeks at 15 hours.
15
times 26, which is the number of pay periods in a year.
So that number is correct.
So that number should be correct.
So that's correct.
And if we go from 36 hours to
20
hours, then it's $27,842 is what the salary would be.
You want to just make it 28? Round number?
We can do that. We could do
20,000.
What's
the 28,000 for the clerk?
No, for the town accountant.
The town accountant.
Make it 28, round figure.
You know what you're going to be paying this person?
We don't know until we start interview.
Well, no, it's not our, and that's going to be one of the questions, is this going to be an hourly position?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So then, if we budgeted at 28, but it's going to be a DOE sort of thing, so whatever turns out, is the personnel board looked at all at what the based on like level of experience, what an appropriate hourly wage rate might be for a town accountant? Is that on the agenda for the personnel committee?
We will probably we're going to do those. We had planned on doing those after the meeting, right, if our handbook had passed, so we've got to finish working on the handbook first. But we are going to be changing the wage and pay schedule.
And it's not for any of us on either one of these bodies to really necessarily tell you how to do this, though the Board of Selectmen could conceivably direct a request to the Personnel Committee to do a wage survey in accordance with good practice when you're posting a position. And maybe put this one out of order.
I know what there are. When I was calling around, even for interim.
There's about an $8 discrepancy from what I remember.
What? Oh, yeah, they're getting...
Huge.
They're getting huge money in the other communities. One community is getting... They're paying it $39 an hour. Another one's paying $32 an hour.
Yeah, so that's why...
I think that's why we're concerned about dropping that, just splitting it by the hours based on the person's...
So now you're dropping it $20,000.
Do you want to say $30,000?
Well, I'm just trying to see what that comes out from an hourly wage perspective, so.
So say $30 an hour, just around the.
Yeah.
Well, I was gonna do it the other way, at 27,842 divided by 1040, which is
money
a half
at the
hour or a half-time person, that's $27 an hour. So, I mean, what did we need?
And what was the 36 hours at,
Well, that's the, 50, hour, that's the hourly rate at 36 hours.
What was the hourly?
$27,
yeah.
Plus change.
Plus change. The other communities are getting much more than that.
What size communities?
All around.
Because I checked in all the communities.
Well, it's not a number that we're going to define tonight. So
no,
what
exactly.
Number,
because we're kind of fishing with the numbers.
Well, I understand that, but from a budgeting perspective.
We're just putting.
We're low.
But we're cutting the hours drastically.
We're dropping it by 20 from what the last one was getting. So.
We're dropping 16 hours.
So from a budgeting perspective, my question to the group would be, do we want to take, it sounds like the low end was about $32 an hour. Do we want to take $32 an hour by 1040, which is what a half-time person gets in a year as a baseline, mm-hmm. And then DOE, if we can't find somebody for that amount, then we deal with it at some point in the future.
We can adjust this.
100%, and we're waiting.
We can adjust this
okay,
down.
So what are we going
to
put
at 32 an hour, what does it come to?
32 times.
Why, 10, excuse me, why are we going at $32 an hour?
We don't
when
even
our,
know.
Our we current don't. Going rate was $27 an hour. I understand about doing surveys in other towns and this and that, but it has always fallen back to what can we afford as well. Now, my suggestion would be to start at the $27 an hour and see what you can get. And then if you can't get someone for that amount, then you raise the amount. You don't start at a higher end and then go even higher if you have to.
You realize I have no intent of that, correct?
No, I don't understand that.
You're talking to a guy that fought a $3 pay for a seasonal employee.
I'm bringing it up because
you're not
the only person.
We're talking about
on
a budget
board,
for 365
so.
Days that mm-hmm. we want to kind of nail tonight.
I get it.
It gives us some wiggle room.
So just as a for instance, restructuring it that way, even if we bake in the potential that to find the right talent to do the right job that we want done in this town, we're still going to overall save over $8,000 by moving to a structure where it's 20 hours a week town accountant, 15 hours a week account clerk.
And what does the hourly wage come up for the clerk?
$13. I did the math at $13 now.
Okay. And I just don't foresee it staying at $13.
So, Steve, I think if we put in 35, we'll be in pretty good shape.
But what does it come out to, the $32 an hour?
It comes out to $33,280.
$35. I just did the math myself.
Are you okay for 35?
I'll make a motion.
That's based on, I'm just going on what you know, I'm just
yep.
basing it on 32 times,
if that
times
number,
20 times
33,280.
50 weeks. Just so you have some kind of a figure.
52.
There.
Well, and you know, okay, why don't we vote on this and then I...
Well, it's not our vote, it's their vote. I'm okay with it.
Yeah, I'm okay with it too.
We don't have to recommend these.
Were you guys good at 35?
I'm all right with it. $35 an hour?
No, 35.
The line item.
$35,000.
For the town account.
For 20 hours? For 20 hours.
Based at 32. I mean, I just plugged that number in, you know.
I thought Beth said 33,280.
Yeah, I did on 50, but I'm just doing it for easy math.
Oh.
So that's why I said 35, you know.
Mm-hmm. Of course, we're telling
you
got to
stop
around,
doing that.
So let's go with 33,280.
This is not.
You got to stop doing that.
No, this is not going to be exact, Marie. Mm-hmm. We don't even know what the figure's going to be.
But when people hear the word, let's round it up.
No, but right now this is a good figure either way, I think. Like I said, if there's a problem in the fall, then we'll have to adjust it.
Well, Can I just say for a minute what a lot of communities are doing? A lot of communities are, because right as of now, four communities in our area are without town accountants.
Right, so they're using services.
They're using services, and I'm going to have somebody come in maybe in a week or so, and they're going to sit down and give us a price for that. So we still really don't know what we're doing. If somebody doesn't want to come on board, because town accountants are far and few in between, and a lot of them are retiring this year, and like the town of Hardwick's been without one for a year.
All right, we haven't even gotten through one.
Yeah, let's
well, well, I was just explaining.
Someone want to make a motion to put 35 into the budget for the town accountant?
I'll make a motion for 35.
For 35?
Someone want to second it? Bob? Okay, Bob seconds it. Marie, you on board with this? Barbara?
Mm-hmm.
It's just
35.
It's a figure that we can, it's a happy medium.
Yeah.
All right, that's a vote.
All right, down to assessors. I have a problem with this. I don't know.
Okay, where are we?
I don't know what discussions you guys have had. My belief when we brought in assistant, whatever we're calling the assessor, it would bring down the three elected officials to a stipend. Where is those three individuals coming in at? 320 or 345?
So that assumes that they're still getting paid some wages for, I think it's Q1 or Q1 and Q2. I'd have to go back to what the department requested. But that's why it goes from 50,000, which was what was budgeted this year. The department requested 19, and that was based off of a 3%. It was based off of the hours they were expecting to still get paid their wages.
So the three elected,
plus the stipend.
The three elected officials are under line item 320?
Yes.
Ooh.
And the assistant is under 345?
Correct.
Okay. And that's with one or two quarters at a pay? And
yeah,
then
I don't remember exactly what they're for. They didn't give me all the details.
So now,
but they're agreeing to transition out to a stipend?
Yes. Okay.
So the assessor's wage is now, this is all three of them, you said included.
The salary includes all three, the stipend and then wages on the two that were previously salaried for, I think, a quarter or two to help transition the new assistant assessor.
And then why the increase on the request for 345?
345?
On line item 345, there's an increase of the request.
That's the 1%.
Oh, that's the 1%.
I just don't have the formula in there. Thank you for helping me with that. That's the formula's not in there for showing the percentage because it was a new line.
Right. Any questions on page two?
And I think the assessors, they're going to be getting, I don't know who said it, but they're going to be getting 1,000 stipend, I believe, when they get the three of them or on board.
1,000 each?
Yes.
I'm not on board with that.
Okay, well, that's what we need to discuss then.
And the consulting.
I tried to get a breakdown from the assessors, but I couldn't get it.
Every other stipend in town's at 500.
Yes, I realize
and
that, Steve.
Then I notice here, what do they have? It says assessors consultant services. Is that a reval year? Because last
yes.
year it was only 2,000.
Yeah, it's a reval.
So they're still going to use. They're still going to use him, even though they have the assistant assessor in there.
Well, because the assistant assessor is going to be doing all the stuff. For the most part, that they used to do.
That's correct.
In
no,
that
but,
office.
Yes, I understand that, but when you have in the consulting service, though.
Yeah, it's an evaluation.
It's a value, but can't the assistant put in a lot of the work, do a lot of the transfer into the computer, or are they still going to have the.
I think they're actually going to be using the consultant as part of the training team for the assistant assessor so that in the future. That person is fully qualified to do a lot of that work.
No,
that was
not,
my understanding.
That's not what I understood.
Well, that's what I understood from that conversation. Is that
then mostly
very
that consulting is mostly for the reval.
For the reval, is that
what
it is? Because that's what it usually is. Because he doesn't
for.
Get involved with
no,
the
No, he
training.
Does not get involved with the guy. No.
No.
No way.
Okay.
So what's on the table right now, Steve, is if how you.
For 320.
I don't know where the 1,000 came from, the stipend. I don't know.
Well,
that was a figure that was given to us.
So the figure that you've assessed in here for the two quarters or whatever at a stipend is 1,000 each.
That's built into it.
So we could technically take 3,000 out of here or even.
No, it'd be 1,500 because if it's 1,000.
Oh, okay, for the year. I'm sorry. All right.
$3,000.
Are you guys okay with $1,000 for a stipend where everyone else is getting 500?
Well, I'm thinking that they're planning on spending more time in there with him.
But that's what they're doing for the first two quarters, and they're getting paid for it. But then, and they've said it in this room that they're just going to transition out to
a couple meetings a month
to implement policies.
He seems very capable of being in there by himself.
It's just the bottom line of what we're willing to pay for a stipend.
Yeah, and I'm thinking that's an FY '18 discussion.
No, it's, but it's buried in here already.
Well, it's currently buried in there.
We're gonna set.
Currently buried in there, but I think to Clarence's point, so for this year, they may still be more involved than perhaps.
But they came before you and said they're gonna be involved for two quarters where they're gonna get paid for it, and then transition out.
Transition into a stipend.
I think the assessor's wage.
And they're gonna get $1,000 stipend for half a year.
That's correct.
Where everyone's getting a $500 stipend for the whole year.
For the whole year.
So it's even more unfair.
I think those two should be separated. I think you should have a line item for assistant assessor and one for the assessors.
For the assessor.
It is.
Oh, it is.
It is.
$345 is for Mr. Jones.
Oh, the $31,000.
Yes.
And $320 is for the three elected officials. I'd recommend that you remove $1,500 from $320. If you base it on a $3,000 stipend.
Yeah, because if two quarters, they're getting $1,000, and then the last altogether, that would be $2,000 that they're getting altogether.
But I still think there should, like you just said, there should be a line strictly stating the three on that board, what the stipends are.
That's what I think it should be.
Just strictly what they're getting.
Well, it's a salary line item, so. I have no problem with it as long as we know that you guys worked out two quarters and then the stipends are there for the other.
We didn't work it out. That was based off the submittal and then the.
But it was for two quarters?
It wasn't broke out. I was just trying to get it broken out.
Are you guys willing to reduce it $1,500?
I'm not willing to, I personally, if we can vote it as a board, I personally wouldn't advise it without going back to the assessors to discuss it.
What do you say, Marie, Barbara, Bob?
Well, I hadn't thought of it like that previously, but it does make sense.
Yeah, I figured the assessors were aligning themselves more with like school committee and board of selectmen than they were necessarily.
School committee's $500.
$500. Planning board's $500. The water commissioners get $600.
So I'm more inclined to agree with Steve. I hadn't thought of it like that.
I think it should be cut back too.
They told us they're gonna be meeting a couple times a month for voting, you know, voting different things.
Yeah, but.
Well, when they get into that role.
Well, that's half the year, that's what they said, you know.
Yeah, we don't know.
Three quarters through.
We don't know exactly what's gonna, when that's actually gonna happen.
And we know at least two of them are looking to retire, so it just, I don't think it's worth the argument.
You wanna wait till the next budget season?
That's my recommendation.
What do you all think about that?
I think you're setting a precedent because you're kind of approved.
I do too. I think you are too, because they're gonna be, if they see that they're making that kind of money, then they're all gonna be changing it on the town floor.
Well, it is a transitional period.
Which they.
For that department.
But.
That's, you know.
But their request is to get paid for the two quarters at an hourly rate and a stipend for the other two quarters.
You know, I don't know for a fact that it's $1,000 stipend.
Yes, they stated it at the meeting. It's $1,000. Yes, I asked them.
I'd highly recommend that we change that.
And I also asked how they came up with that. No one would give me an answer where that $1,000 came from.
So you can entertain a motion, Mr. Chair. I'm done with this.
All right, so someone wanna make a motion at $500 for the.
Will be a reduction of $1,500.
Right, a total of $1,500. Someone wanna second it and then we can discuss it?
I'll second it. Who made the motion?
Well, someone's gonna make the motion first, I guess.
I'll make the motion.
I thought you had.
No.
All right, Barbara, you second it? All right, so where do you three stand? Huh?
I prefer not, but.
So you're gonna put it down, $320 is gonna go down.
I know where you're coming from, and I'm on.
To $1,500.
I'm kind of listening to the two of you, because it's a transitional period. But what happens next year?
But I think we have that communication with them this year about next year's budget, that the expectation would be that next year, when it's in a stabilized board form.
It's gonna be five?
That it's gonna be five. But we just have the conversation this year rather than going after it in case there may be a period of time where you have even a week or two delta from what they calculated the salaries at could affect the overall cost.
if there's a desire for them to have more than the two, and I'm just using the two quarters because that's what's thrown out there.
Yeah.
If there's a desire for them to work another quarter, that's where they come before the town and say, we need more money because he's not ready. We're still needed in this office. And then we'd have to budget for it at a special. But to put another $1,500 in there based on their request for a $1,000 stipend is setting a precedent. Anybody in that position is going to want $1,000.
It is.
No, and you're saying it's a transitional time, which is true, but
they're the
on
ones.
Every other board, when you have a change of people,
they're gonna,
you have a transition.
They're going to change. They're going to want to change all their numbers on.
But they came before you and requested, and not requested, but represented that transition with a dollar amount. And based on that dollar amount, it had the $1,000 stipend in it. And again, this isn't saying you have to leave after the two quarters and go into that.
I don't think they're going to go past those quarters. No way. I don't think they will.
If they have to, they have to.
Huh?
If they have to, they have to, but.
No, you can say that, but.
I'd like them not to, and I agree with you. I think they're in a good position now.
This guy here is pretty decent.
100%.
Hal's doing a very good job.
More than pretty.
I mean, he caught on.
All right, call for a vote, Mr. Chair.
Yes, Mr. Chair. All right, so we got 500 on the vote right now.
It brings it to
500 each.
Yes.
It brings reduce it, the stipend to 500 each.
It yes. Brings it to 17,481.
Do I have us, everybody? So who's all in favor of it? Everybody? Mm-hmm. I am. Beth?
Nope.
Okay, so it's four to one. All right, so it's 500 apiece, and then what's the line? 17.
17,481.
Line 320.
Yep. All right, next page.
God, I went through two pages.
The tax collector's expense, she's okay with the reduction of 600?
Yes.
All right, she's aware of it?
We had that discussion with her while she's in the room.
All right. And she's okay with.
We just took some cushion out.
With 450, treasurer collector.
I'm sorry.
Treasurer collector line item 450.
Tax titles, yes. Because we pointed out that there was funding, still funds remaining in the account that had been encumbered in previous years.
Okay.
So she was comfortable with that.
We skipped over our legal expenses. Did we agree to drop it?
No, we agreed to drop it. You guys were at 68.
Did we agree?
No, I didn't.
Yeah,
we can always go back to the tab on the wall.
I didn't notice because it says a 0% change in it. So.
Yeah.
So 0% change from last year.
David, what line is that?
Well, we requested 60 and then they dropped it down. Did you know?
You just brought it to my attention.
Yeah.
Yes.
So through discussion that we had with you, it was recommended by town council to increase that because of litigation.
Mm.
Are you still going to be going forward?
Yeah, we're in litigation.
We're in executive session under one of them. There's been talk of doing something that we have done before, but it hasn't happened, and I'm not hopeful. Well, I'm hopeful, but I'm not. I don't believe it's going to happen. So I think it's going to go to court.
How much we got in the legal funds right now? That's if it's updated.
Well, that's if the variance report was updated that we have, which
no,
it isn't.
Not.
So,
do we know when we're going to have a updated variance report, at least on the spending side, from the interim town accountant?
I would think 2 weeks.
Yeah, probably in a couple of weeks.
Okay.
She's
coming in Wednesday.
Yeah.
And she was asked to get things looked at town meeting wise to. Did you ask her to come to town meeting?
I haven't asked her. She probably, you think she'll come? I don't know.
I don't know.
So when you say looked at town
to go over
meeting,
numbers,
yeah, go
you,
over
you know
numbers.
How you always had a discrepancy with the levy, with Betty, and just
right.
See what she's got with the numbers. So.
So would it be possible to set up an appointment with me and her to go over what she thinks that the levy limit is going to be and just...
I'll talk to her.
Well, she's got to go over a spreadsheet with us.
Oh.
We discussed it yesterday already?
Yeah.
It seems like last week.
Okay. Doesn't have as many eyes on this.
I'll talk to her and find out, you know, when she feels it might be a good time.
Yeah, there's actually a hidden tab on the sheets that I sent out, that's the levy sheet. So I'd really like her to look at my levy sheet and see if she agrees with it.
We brought it up yesterday, and she's aware of it.
But it is embedded in that same Excel spreadsheet, so if she could take a look at that for me, I'd appreciate it.
All right, so back to 440. Can you please bring that up to 60?
Bob, show up when you got in that last round of figures.
Can we split the difference and go 55? Because I hate having the fox that's watching a hen house tell you what your budget ought to be. And
what's in your note?
21,000 left in the note.
As of what date? 5/4?
Because we've got two things still in litigation.
You know, I'm okay with 55. Are we okay with 55?
Yeah, we'll go with 55.
So do you need a vote for that?
Well, we would need a vote for that.
I'm staying at 50.
Okay, well, I'll make a motion to move it to 55.
All right, somebody want to second 50, going from 50 up to 55?
I'll second that.
Okay. Discussion? Any more discussions? Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
No.
No.
Okay, so that's 3-2.
So we're staying at 50?
Robert, where do you stand?
No, 3-2 passes. Did you say your yes?
Yes.
Okay. You said yes, and I said yes.
Okay.
So bring it to 55? Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
3-2, so it's at 55.
I'm glad I noticed.
I am too. All right, 510, there's a need for that increase?
Yeah, because he's got...
presidential election?
He's got presidential election, then he's got to...
We get the election for Trump.
Then he's got to take Hillary in next year, too.
Which is worse?
Or whoever.
See, that takes in this year, and then it takes
That's
in...
That's an easy answer. That's Hillary's worse.
Next year.
Like that?
So conservation, next.
Okay.
No good answer.
Next page, 560.
Okay.
Oh, that's a total.
That's a total.
My bad.
Conservation wages.
We need to get somebody out of the box.
Yeah.
We need to finish this budget so we can go home.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
I'm working.
Okay.
Board of Appeal, that's 1%. Next page.
Anybody has anything to say on that board, speak up.
Karen, did we put in here for the upgrade of the conversion? We put that in a line item, didn't we?
I thought that was why we went to 15,000 on town hall improvement.
Yes, that's why. We're going to do an article.
Okay, so that's. I just want to make sure it's
that's
there.
That's all in there.
Which dinosaur are you bringing up, Steve?
What do you mean, which dinosaur?
Well, you're going from gas to oil.
The only one that's left down
in the
there.
Hallway.
No.
Okay. That's a hot air furnace.
That's a friggin' dinosaur.
Okay.
Honestly, is it worth upgrading or should we look at trying to fund replacing it?
Replacing it's extremely expensive.
Mm-hmm. What kind of capacity do you need? Just for the hauling.
The problem is that's hot air, the rest is hot water. There's asbestos down there. It's a huge.
You mean to remove it and everything?
You have to remove it.
If you're replacing it, right. But upgrading it, what are they going
to
do?
Just a new burner from oil to gas.
Oh, that's a gas.
Steve, should we have that Tantasqua consultant look at that? Not the third discussion.
I don't know if they deal with that. I think it's more electrical.
Both?
If it's not going to cost us anything, why not?
I think so.
Before we pull the trigger on conversion.
Exactly. Yeah. Again,
what was it you wanted him to look at?
The if we're going to spend $15,000, are there any...
Well, it's not $15,000 for it. It's just...
For an expense towards that furnace. There's a consultant, Fantastic, using it. Does both
for the roof.
Electric and fuel.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
And for energy...
Well, right now we're talking about the conversion.
Yeah. Right, but if we don't...
You wanted to award it, but I said not until the town voted on it.
What Steve had just said is if we don't use that one that we have,
we do
replace it.
We do use it.
Right, but... You're talking about replacing it with possibly electric?
No, okay.
I'm saying there is a consultant that Tantasco uses.
Yeah.
It's like Mass Save.
Yeah.
But not only do they do the electric and the lighting, they also, the company does fuel.
And what do you envision him possibly doing with that?
Making recommendations that we're not seeing.
Yeah. As opposed, you mean recommendations of replacing the burner?
Yeah. Okay. As opposed to what we're planning on doing.
So what happens?
We're planning on replacing the burner.
Right now, yes, but if we have an expert that says something different that's cost-effective to the town of Brookfield, why not listen to it?
Okay, so let's get, so what do you want to use? Do you want to keep this?
No, we're good. I just wanted to see if it was in there.
But we'll talk.
Yeah. All right, next page, line 790. The reduction, is the chief okay with that?
What line is that again?
790.
Yes, yeah, I think his submission was with a 3% increase. So I think when he initially submitted his budget for the part-time wages, it was with a 3% increase.
Okay. Because I noticed too...
Are you saying it's going to go down 1% or are you going to take his recommendation?
No, so the police wage is part-time.
Does that get lumped into the
1%? So what I did was I backed out the 3% increase that was baked into the number that he submitted, and I added back in the 1%. So if you take 55,595 and multiply it by 0.97 and then multiply that by 1.01, that's the number that it comes out.
So you don't want to take the fiscal 16 amount and add the 1%?
No, because he had a change in number of hours requested. Yeah. So I went with his request, backed out the raise, and added the raise back in.
So you backed out his 3% and put in a 1%?
Correct.
Okay.
So that's the change from submission, but it's still a 12% increase because he added some hours.
Then you did the same thing on the clerk's wages, too.
Yes, I backed out the 3% and I added back in
1. Okay, all right. And the police overtime here, too.
And I did the same thing.
Okay. Oh, so he had
but
put
they're,
in...
But they're police, they're contractual. It can't be a 1%.
Oh, that's right. So
I didn't... On the full-timers.
That's right.
No.
So that one has to stay.
You'd want to skip that at 28.
Yep. Sorry, that was a mess. Thank you.
All right, so
I'll make a motion to revote line 810 at 28,000.
It was. Someone want to second that?
Second.
All in favor? So vote.
It is a 25% increase from last year, but it's probably based off the contractual.
He's using more overtime hours, and I questioned him 2 weeks ago on that, and a lot of it's contractual. And
I did the same,
They threw a huge flag up for me 2 weeks ago. 880 was the other elephant in the room. Was the request for...
Well, let's go back up to the police station expenses. Do you see do you see the 20,000 that represents there?
Yeah.
Yep.
Do you realize what it's costing over there for utilities?
I'm assuming by the question it's rhetorical and the 20,000 isn't going
to
cover it.
The gas has been coming in at 1,400 to 1,500 per month. The electricity is 1,400 to 1,500 a month. It's down to $600 to $700 now on the electric only because the solar farm is giving them a credit. Mm.
So with all that information, do you want to change that number?
No, I'm just letting you know that 20,000 represents mostly utilities.
Where are you getting 20,000? I see.
Line 830.
Oh, expenses. Okay, yeah. Not police expenses.
Right.
It's a fixed cost, so is that going to cover it?
Well, we don't know. It's because he hasn't had a full year over there.
Yeah, it's not a fixed cost.
So we kind of weighed it out a little bit.
It might be a little light, but it's at least in the right neighborhood.
Okay.
Yeah. That we can massage later.
Yeah.
Right, back to 880. The discussion, I attended one meeting, had a discussion with a couple people. I'm okay. From what I've heard, you're raising the training to $12 an hour.
Correct.
And that's what that number represents?
Yes. Starting July, fiscal year, July 1st.
All right. And then 885, it says officer salary. Why? Oh, because that was based on the same discussion that we had. They brought it up higher. The discussion that I had with one individual who is an officer states that he doesn't get paid. Have you looked at that? Who's getting paid in that officer's salary line?
The only person on the officer's salary line is the chief.
So the assistant chief and lieutenants don't get paid?
They're paid at rate. My understanding is that the assistant chief, and correct me if I'm wrong, chief, is that the assistant chief does receive an annual stipend.
Yep.
But that all the other, any other like lieutenants type they officers, they just get the regular fireman pay for training or, you know,
one of those officers that isn't technically an officer getting paid in that line item is doing the training, and I've heard is not getting paid for it.
Well, that's an accounting issue. That's not a structural, he's not getting paid issue.
So, Chief, is he getting paid for that training?
He's getting paid the same as the rest of the guys are for the training.
So he's doing the training and getting the same amount? Is that fair?
That piece was, that wasn't part of any version of the...
Well, that's the discussion I want to have tonight.
We discussed bringing up whatever the difference was per year. We wanted to give them the same amount.
But the officer that's doing the training to...
He should be getting...
The on-call shouldn't be getting the same amount of money. This should be...
That's what we discussed trying to do.
But it's not reflected in this budget.
It is not reflected in this budget.
Because we were told that they weren't getting paid. We thought, remember we discussed it with the officers, the only ones getting paid was the deputy chief, well, assistant chief.
Well, for stipend purposes, yes.
That's included.
I don't know, and I'd have to pull up the bylaws and start speed reading in order to get there.
Is there currently more than one
level of firemen allocated within the bylaws currently?
No. The only fire position within the personnel bylaw is the chief.
There is one, actually.
Is there just one lieutenant that's doing the training?
There are two captains, two lieutenants, the assistant chief, and any given night, any number of the people with a significant amount of time will be doing training. That lieutenant...
How many training sessions do you have in a year?
High 40s.
You have 40 training sessions?
We're over there every Monday night. And even on meeting nights, we incorporate training into part of...
And how long is an average session?
Anywhere from 2 to 3 hours.
And there's only one instructor?
No, it's like Monday night we split the group up. That lieutenant was running a training session at the station. And the assistant chief and the senior firefighter were running a training session down the hall.
So technically there's two. Well, statistically there's two.
Yeah.
It's 3 or 4, right? Doing the training?
3.
On any given night, I mean, probably at least 2.
Yeah, okay. I meant overall. Okay.
So is there any way we can calculate this?
They bring them up the same as everyone else.
Well, what's that $170 that's in there for the change in dollar amount?
That was for the chief. The $170 was
you could add another line for training supervisor or whatever, instructor.
What makes more sense is actually to recalculate the fire wages budget from the ground up using different wage rates that we agree on right now for the trainer or for whomever is, or if, and this is a question for the chief, really.
You don't want to put a line item in there, though, that's specifically for the trainer?
I think,
no,
why don't you want to do that?
Because when you start breaking out a lot of those wage lines like that, it creates superfluous and needed answers. And you wind up, from an accountant perspective, having to set up more and more accounts that get cut finer and finer and smaller buckets. It's the same reason why we have a single municipal gas account. It makes more sense to just have a single wages account and actually just calculate the wages from the bottom up. And really, it's how this budget probably should be calculated is, we looked at last year, we had X number of people show for X hours of training. For all of those hours of training, we had a trainer who did this amount. And then one of the questions is, do those people who are qualified as trainers always get paid at a different wage rate, or do they only get paid at a different wage rate when they're providing the training?
Well, we're being told that they get paid the same as an individual attending the training.
I understand that, but not every training is given by one individual. Now, if we want to set up different wage grades for if they're, you know, strictly a firefighter, they get one wage rate. If they're a trainer, they get another wage rate. Is it only when they're training, or is it all the time?
Well, we've already established through this conversation that they're going to get compensated through training. And speaking with a lieutenant, he feels jilted that he's getting the same and not getting paid. He's an officer. He's doing the training, and I'm going to assume that goes for anybody that's training. That's where.
Well, and that's where paying those people a different wage rate
correct.
All the time because they're qualified to give the training would actually make sense. So that's why I'm trying to kick this back to the chief and say,
they should
chief,
get
what would you like to see for if your base guys are getting 12, what's the right number for your trainers, your lieutenants?
I would be comfortable with 15.
See, originally we were told they weren't getting paid. So we had the conversation.
Do you have an opinion?
Am I right? And that kind of,
I recall that.
And that kind of put a crunch into what we when we did the budget. Day.
Oh, he said they weren't getting paid.
So that's why
what
we
do you
were
mean
just.
They weren't,
no,
for the gift, or they were
no,
paid
no, no, that's not true. No, even Steve, the guy even told Steve he wasn't getting paid. So
I think it's a semantics issue saying he wasn't getting paid anything different than the guys who were
he
doing the
be
training
paid.
For giving the training.
Okay, is the chief is obviously qualified to train, I would imagine, right?
I would say he's doing,
okay.
He's doing some training.
I'm just throwing that out there, but we gave him an extra $170.
No, but the point is that he's not the only one who gives the training.
I get that. I'm talking about applying that to
that's
other,
what
other
I,
people that
the
train.
Other ones that we thought went they were just getting like a
but Beth, that's why I'd like to see a separate line item that
right,
goes specifically to the training.
To break it up.
Yeah. Correct. And from what I'm doing, 40 training for two guys, 2 hours each, that's 160 hours for the year. If you add, if you're already giving them 12 hours in the budget,
$12.
You multiply it by three, that's an additional $480 for a year. So you can either throw it into the fire wages, an additional $480, and let the fire
that's
chief.
That's per person?
That's for trainers.
Right, per person.
No, that's total from
just
what
total.
I'm saying.
Just
yeah.
Total for the trainers.
To be divided among.
And that would be at the discretion of the chief. If the chief can understand that.
So wait a second. So $480 and you're basing it off of
what again?
Hours of training?
So I did
four hours
for each session because he said it's split, so and it's usually averaging 2 to 3 hours, so I'm using the 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
So that's 4 hours per session. He said about 40 training sessions per year. That's 160
mm-hmm.
hours
mm-hmm.
times the extra $3 an hour, which is 480.
I don't have a problem with just adding 480 to the number that day.
To the fire wages?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Not absolutely. See, we've got mixed signals. You're saying those guys didn't get paid, or they were getting some kind of a stipend.
I'd recommend bringing that line item to 21.5.
Someone want to make entertain a motion to that effect?
21.5?
Yep. 880, bringing up line number 880 to
right.
21.5.
Well, why wouldn't you just add, for the sake of accuracy, the 480 to that number?
That's what I'm doing. I'm just rounding it.
Yeah, but I don't like rounding, but that's me. I don't like rounding.
I know.
Because it's unintended increases.
But I do. And
so.
Well, a lot of times for accounting purposes, I think it's better to round up.
Now, do we want to make a separate line now or not?
I
just
trust,
let it go
for $480, I trust the chief to delegate it.
Yeah. So what were we rounding that to?
21.5.
Okay. Onward.
You didn't take a vote.
I'll make a motion to accept that at 21.5.
Yeah, you little dictator over there.
Second? All in favor?
Who seconded that?
Actually, you can't second.
Did anybody second
that? I didn't second
it. No, you can't.
I will.
Barbara will.
Okay. Bob, you all in favor? All right, unanimous.
Okay.
Why are we at a 1.2 for line 980?
For which?
980, building inspector assistant.
That's a round up error because it's like less than 40, it's like a 60 cent difference, and it's enough to make it 1.2.
So the figure's too small, though.
Yeah, the figure's too small, the formula.
Next page. Why did the plumbing inspector request, was that a 3%?
That's what it says.
1020?
Yep.
Okay.
It actually comes out to 3.45. No, 4.2. Because of that, built in, 0.4.
Oh, yeah, actually, no, I'm sorry. That, don't ignore that request versus FY15 budget, because if you notice, that is what the requests were per the FY15. I didn't purge that out of the spreadsheet.
So it's supposed to be 3?
No, I'd have to go back and redo the formula. If you want to know what the requests were per,
I'm good.
Just that column is just, it's junk, it's an artifact.
Right, next page, we good? Animal control officer salary, you bumped it? Oh, that's a 1%, my bad.
Yeah, 1%.
The control expense,
yeah, that's, I just
1,200.
We cut it back because we had a lot left.
And did you inform them of that?
Inform who?
The animal control officer.
Do we have one?
Yeah.
Yes. Who is it?
But you don't have an email address.
Amy.
You're
at every meeting. We did it in a meeting. We accepted a resignation and we appointed the assistant.
I wouldn't bump that back because...
But after that point, this was already done before that meeting.
So the assistant is the animal control officer now?
Correct.
Yes.
Who's the assistant?
Amy
Purdue.
Sarah Purdue.
Oh, but Sarah. Amy. Oh, I thought it was Sarah Amy. Purdue.
But anyway, getting back to why we did it before we had that meeting, we had this budget done. The reason we did this is because she had money left in her. In the last few years, she's had money left in that account.
But see, the old one was taking, and she was boarding animals that she picked up at her house.
At her
but
house.
Now,
we discussed
now,
that too.
But now what she's going to do, I think Mike told me, that she's going to have to board them in other communities because she doesn't have a kennel at home. So the,
well,
I think...
All the equipment we bought for her, she turning that back to the town?
No, but she had her own kennel though. Because she had animals.
She put in the expenses for her, for town stuff too. She had them separated.
I don't know.
So we need to get all that back into the town.
You've got to find out what she's got.
And I think you three need to decide if we're going to have another kennel down at the landfill or somewhere.
Oh, that was a long time ago.
I know, it was a nice one though.
Linda, do you want to work with Karen to see if there's any town property?
Okay.
Ms. Fratello's property.
All right, so you get a question on the expenses. So now that you've got a change in plans here, that before we did this, what do you
do?
We did this,
I'd recommend bringing it to the request if it was requested at $2,000.
Yeah, I would put it up to that because she's going to have to pay out to board these dogs. She might need
and,
that
and
money.
And another thing we discussed on the board is we'd like to get we would like to see exactly what this person is doing as an animal control person. How many dogs she's actually taken in, and cats, and how many calls she has, because we're just kind of giving a figure out there, and we don't know what's going on.
Isn't it in the town report?
Is she turning a log or anything?
Well, she's new. She hasn't.
She's new. She just started.
No, I know that.
So
Linda,
didn't she put that in her town report?
Well, that was a different one. So Linda, when you reach out to the animal control officer, can you also reach out to the new animal control officer and request a monthly activity report?
Yeah, we need to do that.
Yeah, you can do that. We'll work with Linda.
Yeah, we can work with
Linda. So there's two things. Just inform her that we do need that activity report submitted to the selectmen. Mm-hmm. And if she has any town property,
okay,
that she can turn that over.
We can work on that.
Somebody want to entertain a motion to bring this back up again on line 1200, I think?
Yep, I'll make a motion.
We're going to bring it back up to the 2,000?
I would.
Okay, somebody want to second that?
I'll second it.
Any discussion? Line 12.
The money's not spent, so
I
can't support it.
Yeah, but we have a forecast. We may not know how many jobs get brought in, but we do know that we are going to have another source of expense at this point if we're boarding with the other communities. If we do decide that we are willing to entertain the liability of setting up our own kennel, then... that's going to cost someone too. So one or the other. where we don't have somebody's private facility, it's probably best to have the funds there.
No, it's not the reserve fund, but we're putting money out there that hasn't been used.
Well, if it doesn't, if it's in there and it doesn't get used, it doesn't get used.
It gets turned back in.
That's all.
So we can buy new vehicles next year with free cash, Bobby.
No, that's where we get that high number.
All right, so did you vote on it?
No.
So who's voting in favor?
Aye.
Aye?
No.
Barbara?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah?
I'm voting, I guess.
Okay, so.
All right.
4-1.
Next page, the last line item, 1385. The request was 1680. Your recommendation was 1248. Was that based on the discussion we had today, the 40 hours till November 1st at 12 an hour?
Sorry, can you repeat the line number, please?
1385, seasonal worker.
Yeah, okay.
That's, you jumped, okay.
Yeah, it's based on the wage rate.
I didn't see any flags on the rest of it.
So the, it's based on the wage rate because the department requested 1680. I think that was based off the old person's wage rate.
Okay.
And we did it from that, from bottom up at, I believe, $13 an hour.
12.
12?
Yeah.
All right, next sheet.
I don't have the calculation in there, so.
And now, line 1250, the tree ward expenses?
Yep.
You got 1750 now, that's 17,500, I should say. Is that what you, is that gonna be adequate now?
You raised that to 1750?
Well, I'm including the shade tree expenses in there.
Oh, I see.
Oh, because this is. Oh, the two together.
I spoke with Herb and asked him if he wanted to raise it. He said he was good with it.
Okay.
So you spoke to Herb, you didn't spoke to Bill?
No, well, Herb pretty much delegates the expense side of it. He gets the sub out there and he.
Herb gets stuff done, so let's give him the money to do it.
Well, I thought it was the tree ward.
It is, it is.
The issue that I have, I think it might be too low if you take a look at the list that the tree ward has. So it's all gonna find and want to get stuff done, but if we're not budgeting against the list of trees that we've supposedly allocated to get done, it's a little hard to get her done.
Well, there's.
You can only get so much done, too.
In a certain period of time, right. We all know there's tons to be done, but.
This is what the tree ward wanted, and this is what Clarence recommended.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's close.
So, we can't. And the way we're cutting trees, Steve, I'm not gonna bring it up tonight, but.
Thank you.
But definitely have to have a discussion.
So don't bring it up tonight and move on.
I just said I wasn't gonna, but what I'm telling you now, I'm forewarning you that we're gonna have a heavy discussion.
Just like you forewarned us about the highway truck in the winter. Thanks for that forewarn.
That's right. We had 3-4 weeks to sit on it, and we did nothing.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
All right, so 1385, seasonal worker. That's good. We answered that. All right, next page, 1390. This was based on the discussion with the request, and the request was denied.
Which line?
1390.
What's your question?
I don't have a question. I just stated.
Oh, they asked for an increase in hours.
In.
Hours. I think it was a 4-hour-a-week increase.
And you didn't approve.
Which would bring it up to?
That's the figure, wouldn't it have been?
No, I mean number of hours.
Oh, they wanted to go from 20 to 24.
Okay.
And did that reason to go from 20 to 24, did that include the Quabog Street grant writing?
What happened when this position was started out, it started out around 10 or 12 hours, and then it went up to, I think, 16 because they wanted to do some grants. And then they says, well, we'll be doing more grants. So then the figure went up to 20. And now we're gonna go up to 24. So we said, wait a minute, now how many hours do you need to do grant writing?
Because some of that grant writing is completed, right?
Well, the.
So it's a new project.
I'm looking at Quabog Street.
Well, Clarence, we had this discussion at a department head meeting, and we allowed Krista to go down there 5 hours a week. So she's been.
Okay.
Down there for 5 hours.
So I think she's gonna continue down there, isn't she, Karen?
I don't wanna see that happen. I don't wanna see that happen indefinitely.
Times 4 weeks in a month, you're at 36 hours more. I mean, how many hours?
It's a whole nother position.
Right, how many hours do we need to?
Is the town benefiting from those hours? That's, I mean, you're the.
We don't know.
But we had that discussion at the department head meeting, and it was agreed that Krista could help.
$10,000 over the last 3 years to get a couple million dollars.
It's administrative.
But we, you know what confuses me too is.
I guess I'm jumping on it.
We have a line for a grant writer already in the budget.
So you want us to pay her out of that?
You could actually fund, if you wanted to fund the extra 4 hours, well, you have the option as the Board of Selectmen, if you choose to fund those extra hours from that line item, the thing that you'd have to settle with the town accountant. We're not recommending that.
But this is where we're coming back to my discussion, that we had the discussion in the department head meeting, and we're using Krista to supplement hours down at the hunting barn.
Yeah, and I'm not arguing that. Where I was headed with it is that there was a complaint that we were adding hours and we weren't getting a benefit. I'm suggesting we were getting a benefit.
Who the heck said that?
No.
That's what
Nobody in this room is going to argue that there's no benefit down there.
We're questioning if they're needed. We're questioning if the hours are actually needed.
We're behind the 20 hours all the way, but my point is, if you listen to me, my point was, how many more hours are we going to keep adding to that position? I mean, how long does it take to do these grants? We keep going up. There's going to be a point where there's not going to be any work to do, and we're still going to be funding this. Right now, we're getting grant money for what we're putting in for her hours, and that's what we want to do. And she's doing an excellent job. But my point is, when are we going to, more? How many hours do you want to do?
So all I'm saying is, to me, this is nickel and dime. Right? What we've talked about is nickel and diming.
We're not nickel and diming.
Just from my perspective,
yeah.
We're talking $1,400 or $1,500 earlier in the conversation. If 4 hours, and again, I'm not saying that we're going there, but if 4 hours benefited you for a couple $100,000 in town benefit.
Don't you want to do that?
When does the need for what she's doing end?
Problem is if you're because those funding,
she has the hours.
The grant writing cycles continue. And one of the challenges you run into.
That's correct.
And one of the challenges that you run into is just sometimes just because the project is over doesn't mean that the paperwork's gone away. Okay. Some of these larger projects, you're still dealing 6 months, 8 months, a year afterwards. You're still dealing with Army Corps of Engineers.
But that's the managerial side that we've already dealt with. We've supplemented.
Right. Because I mean, how many? But Clarence, I'm going to make a point here.
Yep.
How many hours do you want to allocate? Right now, we got down there for 80 hours plus 20. So we got 100 hours of paperwork per month. So my point is, how many hours do you want to keep? We're getting grants. That's good. That's what we want. What you're saying is we're missing grants. We're not missing grants. How many hours? Well, my point, listen. How many hours are we going to, 100 hours of paperwork down there for the highway? How many more hours do you think we need to put down there?
So my point was, I'm not smart enough to know. How's that? There's an employee that writes grants for the town. They made a recommendation.
That's good.
Good. And so she had recommended something, or they had recommended something. Mm-hmm. You pulled it back. I'm totally, I mean, that's your job to pull it back.
That's
what I'm saying is, did you do a cost benefit for that retraction? And if the answer is yes, you did a retraction, then.
No, the answer is no. In what he's talking about from a standpoint of ROI and fundamental business style cost benefit analysis, absolutely not.
Yes, we did.
Who is this?
Absolutely not.
I think we should be moving along.
At what point does that position become a benefited position?
She's already benefited.
She's already benefited?
20.
Yep. At 20 hours?
It's at like 16 or 18 in this town.
It doesn't impact
the current benefit rate.
Okay, you guys voted on it. We're okay with it. Can we move?
Are you sure, Clarence?
You guys can have this.
No, just like you're coming back to throw something under the table again, I will also, because I think that this town can
benefit. Just tell me we did diligence on this budget, and I'm just explaining.
I didn't say you didn't do that.
We all appreciate that individual benefits this town.
We do.
Very much.
Line item 1540. Are you just using the same old number? You remember that we needed more money to pay. You remember that we needed more money for that line item, right?
Street lights.
Yep.
And you put it down.
And it looks like you just did it to match last year's.
Yeah. What causes that to go up when the cost of
the electric rate.
Fuel, but the cost of fuel has gone down.
It's the electric rate.
Had to right. Because you,
Are you getting, are they, I thought they were swinging something in from the solar. Does the solar affect those streetlights?
No, I don't think so.
Yes, it does affect.
Okay, so, because you guys, someone did a recalculation of where the different stuff was going.
Yeah.
And that's why we didn't change it.
You can keep it at 11, but just remember, we came at you last month with a request and.
Because the rates went up.
And you approved it, so.
And that doesn't change, because the streetlights.
All right, where do you want to go to then?
Oh, no, I'm not.
It's basically just a.
Well, the request was 14, so whatever you guys want to do.
Have you guys thought about changing your supplier?
The last time this town tried to do that, tried to do one of those collective bargaining.
No, it's not collective bargaining, it's changing your supplier to a different, somebody besides National Grid. National Grid still supplies the, you know, the infrastructure, but the actual supplier, they're the distributor.
Distribution.
But you can get different suppliers.
Washington Gas, that's solar.
Oh, that's the solar.
No, I'm thinking like, there's Meridian, there's Constellation.
No, I just think it gets complicated.
It doesn't, they just switch the account over and it's like that.
Say that that's a study that needs to be done.
Yeah.
And I would look to the advisory board for that recommendation.
Now, how many more hours are you going to add to us to get all this work done, Clarence?
I'm working a few hours.
Are we getting paid more than 4 hours?
I'm not getting paid anymore for spending an extra hour here, so.
So let me throw a compromise on the table since it's 8:30.
We haven't gone past 9 yet.
We're going to. $1,500 over to cover you for the rest of the year. So let's add $1,500 to last year's budget, and if we wind up coming up a little bit short, then we'll deal with it at the end of next year.
So $1,250?
And take us to $1,250.
$1,250. You got a vote on that?
Yes.
Someone want to entertain a motion for $1,250?
I'll make a motion to move it to $12,500.
Someone want to second it?
Second.
No, in favor?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next page.
Cemetery superintendent.
What line you
that's
on?
That's the same. 15, oh no, I'm 70, sorry. 70. I'm sorry. I'm all right. Never mind.
It's late, isn't it, Linda?
Yeah, it is. It's getting late.
What line are you on?
I'm on the next page. All right, I'm on the next page after that.
Yeah, but what line are you on?
I'm on line 1760 page.
Okay, that's where I'm at. Okay.
Oh, this is all right.
I didn't see anything. You can go through it.
No, I don't see.
You caught one on me that I didn't catch.
Yeah.
You going to the next page, Mr. Chairman?
I'm at.
1830. Why the decrease on request?
Because we have fewer veterans. That was actually his request.
You have a fear of veterans?
Fewer.
Oh. Fewer?
I don't know why he went to.
Only you, bud. Only you.
not at all.
Oh, and the reason why we had a different number than he did was because the number he'd given us per veteran was 17,000 on average, which is a plus or minus number.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's the reason why we went there. You know that we could adjust it at the special.
That's a constant moving target.
I understand that. Totally understand that.
And he's okay with that 55?
He didn't say anything.
Did you inform him?
I think he did.
I think we did talk. Yeah. I think that might have been when he was in the room.
You were able to get in touch with him?
Yeah, no, I think he was actually in the room.
He actually came in the room.
I think we talked to him about it, but honestly, it was months ago, and I
came into the.
I wouldn't put my hand on a Bible right about now.
Just understand that could come back to bite us.
Yeah. Because we've got to have that.
No, because what happened when he got jumped on two more people from 4 to 6, so he came back and we had to hit the.
Well, the department.
Went to the reserve fund.
Okay. The department requested 58,000. We did 55,000. It's only a $3,000 difference.
Right. No, I'm just telling you.
So if he comes back, he has to have that money.
All right, next page, line item 1920. You're actually giving them more than what they requested?
Yes, because they actually followed instructions.
From the state.
They followed instructions from the original memo that went out to the departments. It said very specifically to level fund wages until a determination was made about that.
This isn't wages, this is periodicals, books, videos.
That's the state.
You have to go up to meet the state requirements, and that's why we went up.
Yeah.
So, but why did they request a different figure? Shouldn't they be aware of that?
Because she went along with the FY16.
Oh, she went along with the level funded?
Yeah, that's what she did, if you look back.
So she went along with level funding on the wages.
And then we
actually plussed up the books, videos, periodicals. I think what had happened was, you know what? I had the conversation with her, and she actually told me that her submission was good because it's a formula, actually, and it's like 2.5% off of average off of the last 3 years. So her original submission was actually okay. I had plugged that into the budget so that we didn't under budget it.
Okay.
Just 2 years ago we did that.
Well, it's not under budget. It went up 2.5.
Right.
All right, I'm on to a couple pages ahead, 2180. And you guys feel
what
free
are you,
to
Eleanor Wood's speed reading.
No, I'm on 2050 right now.
Well, you can go 2050, whatever you want to do.
Well, we got to go through this first.
You can keep going through it. I'm just telling you where I'm at.
All right. Well, our board's at 2050 right now.
Your board's all done.
No, we're not done yet.
You already did this budget. You're done.
No, we have to review it now.
That's what we're doing now.
Okay, so 2050.
Okay.
You have a question with 2050?
No, I'm just saying that's the beginning of the page.
Okay, next page, 2180.
Anybody have any questions on that one? Okay.
2180, the request was 16.5, and you brought it down to 14. Was that with the discussion through the treasurer?
2180? Yeah, I think it was.
2180.
You brought, yeah.
We had that discussion with
Sandy. Yes, that was a discussion that we did actually have with Sandy, and it was based off of our spend the last couple of years on that.
So she's okay with it?
She was at the time okay with it.
Yeah.
Mm. And then I see here you left the group insurance. Was that with the new, didn't they have a 5 or 6% increase on that?
The request was.
But I mean, shouldn't she, that's what she requested, because you know, sometimes a lot, she gets extra people that come on.
But the request is larger than.
Okay.
Yeah, the request is significantly larger than last year.
All right, law 2260, the decrease in the request. Both 2260 and 2270.
That was submitted at 3%.
Right.
Okay. So that's for all of it then.
Yep.
That's why, Steve, that's why when the book gets printed, I don't want to put that in the book because it just causes,
that's where I'm flagging my things right now.
No, I mean, it's great, but I mean, it's good for us, but I'm just saying it's just, you know.
Just so you know, based on what we all reviewed just now, when we take it down to the 2340 operating budget, this budget represents a percentage change of only 1.6% including the school budget.
1.6%.
Good thing this town's spending beyond its means, huh? And we're the cause of the tax increase. Yeah. All right. I'm good with that.
Well, that's what we're trying to do on this board, Steve.
That's what we've done for every year that I've been involved in this town. Yeah.
And yet our taxes are almost $20,000.
That's because we got too many deadbeats.
That's one reason.
All right, so any questions on the budget? We good?
No, I think we're
good. Any other questions on any of these three issues?
Yeah, it's all in here.
Collective front, I am extremely appreciative of the work that you guys have done. Thank you very much. Do you have any questions from us?
We're appreciative of the work that you do as well.
Thank you, ma'am.
Well, you do a good job, all of you.
I'm not gonna
vote to give each one of you $500 on the town floor. Are we okay with that?
Okay, I'm good with that. Okay.
You gonna give us more hours?
Yeah. Oh, I'm going to double.
How many more hours you want us to work?
Double.
I'm hitting send here in about 30 seconds so that what we just reviewed, and I did not rehide the columns for the budget requested.
That's going to come off.
No, I understand that. For the one that's getting printed in the book, I got it. Message loud and clear.
But are you sure?
Yes, but for, you're going to see a copy of it before it goes to the print.
Right.
But for the purposes of the select board, you want to leave those columns in the copy that I send you?
I'm good. I'm done.
Well, I know that was one of the requests. Remember, I mentioned that when we had our roundtable discussion, they wanted the townspeople to see what they had requested.
We denied that request.
They can just say we requested 3%.
Thank you.
That kind of pretty much.
No, they wanted their whole budget.
As far as I'm concerned, and you saw the questions that I asked tonight, was the department head aware that we lowered that amount?
So they are aware.
You need to hide that column because it will cause total chaos on the floor.
Okay.
Thank you, Steve.
But it was extremely beneficial for tonight's meeting.
It was good.
All right, so I'm going to entertain a motion to enter into executive session number two to conduct strategy sessions in preparation for negotiation with non-union personnel, or to conduct collective bargaining sessions, contract negotiations with non-personnel, and to re-enter into open for the sole purpose of adjournment.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Come to our eye.
Lincoln, aye.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.